We're back. Opie and Anthony. Full house today. Going around the room, we got Patrice O'Neill.
She's going
to be playing Bananas Comedy Club in Poughkeepsie.
Yeah, man. Finally, I don't have to get on a plane. Just drive on out.
Nice. Two shows tonight, two shows tomorrow, right?
Yeah, man.
I'm sure they're selling well.
I hope so.
They better.
Last time I was there, man, it was a great time. People out there were great. It's amazing.
Also in studio, Joe DeRosa, and we're making believe that we don't notice that he's lost a shitload of weight and he doesn't exercise. He'll be at the Stress Factory this weekend.
Yes, sir.
Tonight and tomorrow, recording a comedy CD.
Yes, sir.
So we want to bring you back to make sure we get a nice crowd there for you, Joe.
Name of the CD is called My Last Stand. Joe. I ain't going to make it. Joe DeRosa.
Called The Next Bill Hicks.
Why do you have to take it to reality?
It's not that much weight I dropped, right?
Yeah, you look.
And Joe sounds a little bit like Bill Hicks at times, so, you know.
Yeah.
He's starting to look like fruit.
We're a little nervous for you, Joe, because we know you don't work out or eat right, so why the fuck are you losing weight?
I've been eating. I stopped drinking. Maybe that's what it is.
You look like the allies are ready to liberate you.
Look at him pulling his fucking neck skin.
I keep throwing out ideas and nobody's biting on any of them.
No,
to make me feel better. Like, oh, maybe I stopped drinking. Nobody's like, oh, yeah, maybe that is what it is.
Joe,
like,
no, that's Joe, here's the problem for real. You were here Tuesday? Wednesday? Mm-hmm. Tuesday?
Yeah.
You've lost weight since Tuesday. That's what I'm getting at. Because Tuesday we didn't say, wow, Joe, you're losing weight.
Well, I've eaten decently since Tuesday. And I'm in the first three weeks of no booze. I mean, you start dropping the weight quick.
That's what you read on Dr. MD.
WebMD.
WebMD and shit. WebMD.
Don't ever go to WebMD. That shit will scare the fuck out of you.
Booze is the only thing keeping the cancer off your liver.
Oh, fuck.
Jesus Christ.
I'm not going to be able to take my nap after the show today. I'm going to be so nervous with a stomach ache.
You feel all right, Joe?
Yeah, I feel pretty good.
Jesus. He doesn't want to say good because he's just scared.
Pretty good. You all right, Joe?
It's karma. You know what kills me, motherfuckers? Like, Joe, I think Joe's an atheist, right? Aren't you an atheist, Joe?
Yeah.
See, I love when atheists get sick. Now it's like, he's trying to have karma, and he's like, I feel okay, hoping that God's going to fucking fix it.
It's great to be an atheist until you get sick.
Exactly.
And like, oh, fuck.
Or the plane's going down. Who are you praying to, motherfucker?
There's no one to pray to.
Oh, please, Patrice, make it fix.
What in God's name makes you think when you kick it, you're going to go anywhere near heaven? If it does exist.
Because I'm going to fucking ask for forgiveness. That's what I was told.
They found a picture of you, Joe.
Oh, my God. Joe. Danny just pulled up like an Auschwitz picture.
Joe's the pianist. Joe.
And he's wearing a baggy little fucking.
I don't even
want to see you without that on.
And he started out with the worst body you can have is a skinny fat guy. He's a 120 pound fat man, and it really bugs me. He's 6'2", 120 pounds of fat.
What happened? Joe, you glad he came back?
I don't know. I'm gonna go to an urgent care today after the show. I'm fucking nervous. God. Is it really that much weight?
Oh, yeah, you built like a fucking spider.
Danny pulled up the machinist. That's fucking hilarious.
The machinist. You look like a Close Encounters alien.
How the fuck did Christian Bale do that for that movie? It's amazing.
He's his next movie was like Batman.
Yeah, no. The Machinist was awesome.
I'm saying he's an asshole for that. Like,
for doing that?
Oh, it's just, you know, I don't mean he's a dick. It's like a dick, but it's just like, you dick.
Right. Go through that.
What you call did it too. Tom Hanks did it.
Not like that.
Castaway.
Christian Bale fucking did it.
Yeah, look at the difference.
Man. That is a fucking skeleton. Human skeleton.
Thank you for not saying Philadelphia to not make me think of AIDS again.
Yeah.
Let's find an old picture of Joe DeRosa on our show just to compare.
Is
that Joe DeRosa?
That's Joe DeRosa Tuesday. Tuesday's Joe DeRosa.
I like using an exfoliating scrub.
Look, I don't look that much thinner than in that picture there, do I?
Oh, shit. Go back. Go back to the bunch of pictures. Yeah, look at this healthy one there.
Oh, my
Tell us when
God.
These pictures were taken. When was that picture taken?
Shit.
Like 2 years ago?
Oh, damn, man.
Look at his hair.
Off.
Dude, look at Joe's face right there. Look at his fucking face, man. healthy, good-looking Egyptian kid.
You got a glow to
full
you.
Head of hair.
I've been smoking a lot.
How many years ago was that one?
Oh, my God. Look at this.
That's like 5-6 years ago. Wow. That's a terrible picture.
Wow. Right. Did you just get beat up after 9/11 looking like that? You look like an American guy now. You look like...
That's back when I had Danny hair in that picture.
Point out the most recent picture in Google Images of you so we can
Go back to the first page.
First page. Mm-hmm. All right, we're going back to the first page.
It's probably...
Right here. Which one?
No, that's a couple years old.
Which one?
Danny, go to that one where I'm looking... I can't see the fucking thing.
Just count.
I can't even see anymore.
Count. Scott, he's blind.
He's fucking going
blind. That red shirt one's from last year, I
think. This one? Okay. All right, this is last year.
Look at the deterioration.
Oh, my God. You must have like a double chin.
Got something. Joe looked fan. Joe was handsome in his first. Look at Joe.
Oh, my God. What's going on with
you? He fucked that girl he's standing next to.
Yeah.
You better be training for the New York City Marathon, my friend. Or you might have a problem.
I got tired of the curly hair.
No, he didn't. Who gets tired of full curly hair? Who gets tired of that?
Full.
Can you tell me who gets tired? Look, I'm going gray. That's why my shit's super low. You don't cut your hair super fucking low.
I cut it short. What do you think? It wasn't falling out.
Don't get mad at me, sick boy. We're trying to help you fucking come to grips.
So this is it. This is how I'm going out.
Bro. Who takes a shiny, thick fucking carpet like he had and then shaves it down to look like fucking Willem Dafoe?
Yeah, that fucking Greg Brady hair going, that curly fucking...
And after you hear that, you know what I mean, 800 fucking times, you shave it down. You get tired of having the, you know...
You get tired of looking delicious, so you fucking just chop it with a lawnmower.
Why you like this?
You don't like it like this.
I do.
Something's going on with Joe, man.
In the morning, you just shampoo it.
Yeah, I don't even shampoo it. There's nothing to fucking shampoo. I don't have to worry about lice.
Oh, don't worry. A couple of more months, there'll really be nothing.
Don't have to worry about anything.
Until the chemo starts. Oh, that's what he's getting ready for. Oh, shit.
He would ease into it slowly.
Look at this
look
douche.
At that.
That's
look
you?
At
that.
That's a different guy. He even looks good as a douchebag. Look at him.
That is a fucking... They found that passport photo outside the World Trade Center. God,
they had to pull it out of the ashes like this.
Yeah,
dust it off.
All right. Well.
God damn.
Now I stopped drinking. I've been smoking like a fucking chimney for the last couple weeks. It's probably making me drop weight.
Smoking makes you gain weight.
No, it makes you drop weight. You gain weight when you quit. Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right.
I've been smoking like half a pack a day.
Yeah, Muhammad Atta hair. You did. Look,
me and Patrice have a lot of body language going on right
now.
Yeah,
I know. I see.
That's nothing to do with what the show's doing.
Yeah,
I'm just not falling for it.
Nah.
It's not contagious. That's all
there
I need
to know.
Look.
Muhammad Atta and Joe DeRosa.
Do you have a tapeworm? Maybe you have a tapeworm.
My brother.
A tapeworm?
What year is this?
How would you do?
Maybe you have a consumption.
I think I have rickets.
Start digging through your shit and make sure nothing's like moving around in there.
Anything, how do you get
anything what?
Anything like feel different on you lately? Changing any habits aside from not drinking?
I am eating
melting.
Better. I'm eating better.
You're eating better? What? You eating grape?
He's not eating
grape day.
He's not eating better.
You know, a grape here and there, half a grapefruit, some cereal.
Yeah, he's having a nice, better cup of coffee.
You know, coffee.
Morning.
I'm drinking a lot of coffee. That might have something to do with it.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, it's the booze, man. It took it.
Go back to drinking.
I think I look good. I look thin. I think I look better than I did in those double chin fucking Paul Giamatti photos you were pulling up of me. You know.
Yeah, well, people got to get used to it, I guess. It's just when you
Joe, no one noticed that you... People, this is what people said. This is people's minds when you walked in. Oh, Joe lost a lot of weight, but he doesn't look good.
And you lost it.
You
the
see
week.
How Bobby looks? Bobby
you
looks
lost
good
it in 3 days.
Yeah. Bob looks good.
We didn't have this discussion Tuesday. Yeah. You were here.
Bob lost weight.
Really,
looked healthy.
I really look like I lost weight since Tuesday.
Yeah.
Are you fucking with me right now?
We would have done this break Tuesday.
Did you run over an old gypsy woman, and then some guy came up to touch your cheek?
Thinner.
Thinner.
Am I cursed? I'm going to change my name to Lawrence Talbot.
She gave him a cherry pie with his fucking...
with a blood in there.
Full of his act that he's going to do tonight. Just gets so fucking sick.
Let's
go fucking hire Joe.
I will be
Joe Pagliantani. Who's the motherfucker that helped him out in that movie?
Oh, Joey Pants?
What? Was the motherfucker that plays the voice of The Simpsons, the gangster, that was helping him in dinner? He helped the gypsy.
Joe Pantoliano?
Nah, fuck it.
Oh, Joe Montana.
Joe Montana. Oh, yeah. Joe Montana beat up the gypsies. I need somebody to beat up some gypsies.
All right. Jesus.
Opie's like, man.
Joe.
Yeah, you're all right.
You're all right.
He's good.
I see what you guys are doing. I see the fucking evil head games you guys are playing with me right now.
You're fine.
You get me all worked up, then you say I'm fine, then you say I'm sick,
there
then you
is
say
no,
I'm fine.
But okay. You get a taste of reality.
There is no...
We're not trying anything.
Yes. When you walked in, people are like, what the
How long
fuck
ago did
is
you
going on with Joe?
Stop drinking.
Almost 3 weeks.
3 weeks? Mm-hmm. Did you drink a lot? How many beers?
I was drinking 4 or 5 nights a week and completely shit-faced, so, you know.
That's a lot of calories, right?
You know.
Well, what the fuck doesn't... Liquor doesn't make you gain weight.
Are you kidding me? Beer is so many
beer
calories.
Beer makes your stomach fatter, right?
My stomach's gone down
a lot. But you don't
lot,
have a
dude.
Beer belly.
I did. My stomach's grown way down, dude. That's, like, great for my stomach, man. Don't fucking make that face at me as I watch your medallion sit on top of that fucking shelf you got coming out of the middle of your body. It looks like they're on display. His medallion just shit.
But here's my thing. I'd like to see that one. I'm a consistent fat man. This is what bothers me. Is a guy that could pretend that he's in shape. Like, when I walked in, you don't go, hey, Patrice, you're looking terrible.
Yeah, right. I am.
I lost a couple of pounds.
Honestly, we've never thought that.
You just come in there.
It's just Patrice.
You go slow.
Right.
Joe's on some 3-week I don't drink diet where people go, what? You don't look good.
You're supposed to look better if you stop drinking.
Coming in here looking like a funny zombie. Did you see Paranormal Activity, my friend?
Not yet.
Nah.
You liked?
How was that?
It sucked.
Blow it up if you don't think it's good. Everyone's talking about how great this thing is. It was made for what? $800 or something?
It looked like two things.
$11,000.
I'm fed up with home camera movies. And
you really?
It's done. I'm done with them. And secondly, the movie should have been called Go Get the Number to Wykurt Realty so we can sell this fucking house that this demon is in.
Oh, really?
This movie made me sick. Blair Witch Project 2012.
Is that what it is?
But the Jamie Foxx movie we was talking about, saw that. Great movie.
Wait, slow down with the let's go back to Paranormal because everyone's going to try to see that movie.
Well, go see it.
But what, you just hate it, why?
The same way I hated Blair Witch Project. I wanted to take a shit in the theater.
People think Blair Witch Project was the fucking shit.
Did you?
I hated that fucking
movie.
I'll
be completely honest with you. Exactly. Ready for this one? Exactly. Never saw the movie.
Why?
I don't know.
You didn't miss nothing.
I've never seen that movie.
It sucks.
That's one I've never seen.
Nothing scary about Paranormal Activity. I rewinded it 6 or 7 times.
You're not supposed
really?
To be rewinding because you're not...
Oh, I mean, I went into 4 or 5 different theaters. As I was...
Maybe you hated it because your copy sucked. People were talking through the whole movie. Maybe that's why. Maybe you got a bad copy.
So it wasn't scary? Because some of the scenes kind of looked like, oh, that would make me jump.
Yeah, what's that weird shadowy thing that comes flying at the camera? That looked like it could scare some people.
You didn't jump? You don't jump at movies at all, do you? Do you jump at scary movies? What do you consider scary movies?
Fair enough. I never was afraid of supernatural anything.
Yeah.
So that's one thing. So maybe I'm just not the right guy. Supernatural is not... I'm afraid of
real shit that could happen to you.
The Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the original.
Yeah.
When the girl comes out, or when the guy falls in, and this nigga just has a hammer, and he snorts and hits him in the head and hangs him on a hook.
Yeah.
Or the bitch comes out the fucking... Right. the bitch comes out the room.
Yeah.
And he opens that door, that butcher closet with the iron door, and he's squealing, and she runs, and that fucker chases her.
Yeah.
And grabs her before she gets out the house, and then hangs her on a hook and beats her in the head and puts her in a fucking freezer.
That
Texas Chainsaw Massacre is one of the scariest movies I've ever seen.
That doesn't scare me. That kind of slasher fucking shit.
That's better than a slasher.
Yeah,
movie.
I understand, because there's like real thriller shit to
it.
It's psychologically fucked up shit. But for me to jump, like The Ring, fuck me up.
I laugh at.
See, no, any of that weird
scary children
shit.
No, make that's me the problem. Laugh.
No, see, now it's easy to say scary children make you laugh because now it's been overplayed. But when that shit
Exorcist
first happened,
did
you're
nothing
like, what
for
the
me.
Fuck?
No, The Exorcist is scary.
And The Ring was fucking scary.
That's the problem, though, with most horror movies now, is you're talking about jumping. They're all like, they all rely on these knee jerk scares. You know what I mean? Like, that's the beauty of Texas Chainsaw Massacre or The Exorcist. They create this mood. From the first frame of Texas Chainsaw Massacre, you're just like, what the fuck is going on? I don't feel right. This is weird. You know what I mean?
That's a good
one. But
way
like
to
The
put
Ring, it's just normal. They do those violin screeches. You know what I mean?
The Exorcist, the one scene that bothered me is the one they added later in the spider walk.
That's creepy.
That creeps
See,
me
that
the
kind
fuck
of, that made me laugh.
Out.
When there's someone all fucked up walking on the ceiling,
that
all
shit made
fucking
me laugh.
Weird, that shit I can't look at. It freaks me out.
You know what she did? I guess The Exorcist is kind of fucked up.
It's fucking scary.
You know what she did, cunting doctor? That shit is fucking.
She keeps the blood into the camera?
Dude.
That's all right.
That's
scary.
Scary.
If it was such a great fucking scene, why didn't they put it in the original?
It's too scary.
They said they cut it out of the original because they thought it was too scary too soon. They wanted you to wait longer to get to the creepy shit.
Yeah, so they wanted to piss on the rug first.
And he said he didn't want you to think she could get out of the room. He said he thought it was scary if she was up in the room. But how scary is that fucking premise? Like, it's your daughter, you can't leave the house, and this thing is just living up in that room above you the whole time. Oh, it's so fucking scary.
I think I saw the Exorcist like 20 years too late.
maybe.
Like 20 years too late. Like, my mother learned how to paint after the Exorcist. Like, she couldn't sleep. She started
really?
Yeah, after she saw it, she couldn't sleep, so she was up all night just painting.
Yeah, that fucked people up, The Exorcist.
It was shocking.
I can't watch it alone. It freaks me out.
Still?
I can't watch it by myself. When she sticks the cross in her pussy, it's like, oh my God, dude.
Hot, right?
Yeah.
But I just don't believe in paranormal shit.
See, that shit gets me all the time, the paranormal stuff, because if I ever saw, like, a fucking ghost or anything like that, and not like a boo sheets over him ghost, you know, like a real fucking ghostly thing, I'd shit myself. I would fucking shit my pants and be like,
so ghost.
Dude, let's...
That scares the piss out of
let's
me.
Let's spend the night in an old prison or something. Let's go to some fucking haunted place and
I'd be more afraid of a bum that was living there
really
than the ghost of Al Capone.
I'm afraid of anything I can't shoot.
And we'd be scared.
hold on. Would you spend a night in some fucking supposed haunted place?
No. Why would I do
Let's
that?
Let's do it.
I'll do it.
I would
do it.
Why? Let's get a gang together and do this. How do we get this done?
Tell me how.
Someone's got to know.
You find a haunted fucking house in New York, first of all.
No, it's got to be like one of those weird prisons or like a fucking old ship or something. Some weird
pilgrim,
fucking.
We'd have to travel to fucking San Francisco. Where's their old prison?
Pilgrim State Psychiatric Center.
Yeah, that would be scary. I think there's one in Philly.
An old prison.
We could drive to Philly.
Old Quaker prison. I'd be scared of the Quakers that still live there.
Dude, it's got to be somewhere where someone was killed.
We got to find the perfect place, and it's got to be someone, a fan of the show, that could get us in there for the night.
Aww.
And we'll film that shit, Patrice.
Call that TV show.
We'll see how scared you get.
Call that TV show.
Ah, see, I don't like this shit.
What?
Ah, fuck.
What, the fucking ghost and shit?
I'm not looking. There's ghostly. What is this from?
It's real ghosts, Anthony.
Yeah, it's just like a 10-minute collection of ghost footage.
Yeah, but I know it's all done with fucking, like, After Effects and Adobe products.
Do you believe
me? No, these are real ghosts, dude. They're coming for you.
But it's very scary.
Anthony, when I'm dead in 2 weeks, will you be scared when my ghost appears to you?
Fuck yeah. Look at that.
You beat me to the line. I was going to say, we got a future ghost in studio.
Oh, shit. Wait a minute.
I got to cut myself before you guys stab me. I got to fucking take it on myself.
You weren't born yesterday.
That's fake poltergeist shit.
Come on, man. Let's. So, Patrice, it's me and you so far, and you got to do it if we do it.
Ant's scared to
death. We spend a night in a fucking haunted fucking place.
I think I'm going to. If Anthony goes, I'm not going to go. I'm going to tell you why. He's going to bring a Desert Eagle.
Oh, yeah.
And any false moves, one of us is going to do.
It's getting fucking nailed.
By the way, Patrice, I'm counting on you because I will be scared. And I'm just hoping you fucking joke your way through it. Because I will get fucking scared one of these fucking joints.
It's like, look, man, here's... Okay, can I tell you why I don't believe...
Some people say the Comedy Store in L.A., that fucking basement, they refuse to
go
down.
It's haunted by hacky comedians.
Yeah.
Some people swear that... I mean, that back room of the Comedy Store is pretty creepy.
The ghost of Red Skeleton's down there.
Freddie Prince.
Let me tell you why... ghosts and aliens. I believe in life in the universe. I don't believe there's aliens on Earth and never was. And I don't believe in ghosts because of what they do. Ghosts never go, hey, I'm a ghost. Let's talk. It's always something creepy and childish.
Their
job is to go, I'm going to peek around the corner and fuck with you. I don't believe...
What would you do if you were a ghost? That's what I would be doing.
I would fucking be trying to stop.
fuck me. No.
What was that?
All right, let's do
Rewind this.
Rewind
that.
There's a baby. There's a kid fucking...
And it's fake.
I don't care. It's scary.
Let's do this shit, man.
Opie,
That's why you sleep with so many guns, you pussy. I just realized, Anthony...
Guns don't kill ghosts.
You motherfucker!
You gotta get a Ghostbuster to live with you.
Get a big magnet.
This is a big magnet.
And fuck up their
electronic impulse. Fucking.
Don't get Ernie Hudson to live in your house. He has nothing better to do these days.
Oh Jesus Christ! Come on,
eat a ass.
Patrice makes a good point though. Ghosts are passive though. Right. If you had all that power over people, why wouldn't you
Games. It's the games that they make the ghosts play.
Peek-a-boo and hide and seek and all that shit. Like, why would you do that?
Boo, I'm going to make you barely think I exist.
Right.
Just fucking smoke a cigarette, nigga.
Fucking
talk.
Do it.
And look at the clip. Look at the clip. There's no way that's haunted. They have IKEA furniture in there.
No, but I understand, like, this isn't real, but it's that type of shit in movies that fuck me up. Like, look at that, obviously.
So you really, the paranormal fucks with you then?
That is the scariest shit ever for me in movies and stuff. Right.
The ring.
All right, hold on, before you get into that.
The clicky...
Yeah.
Hold on, because I don't want to lose our opportunity here. Chris, what do you got?
Yeah, there's a fucking haunted mental hospital in Philly. It's on Byberry and Roosevelt Boulevard. Kids I went to school with used to go there and fucking drink, and I don't know, they said there was ghosts. I never fucking went there.
Would you sleep there, Patrice? I mean, we're not doing no sleeping. We're fucking hanging out all night at one of these motherfucking
places.
Bobby Kelly has to go.
But he said, would you go in... This is my thing. He said, would you go in a haunted house to sleep? I said, yes. And he goes, would you go there and say, fuck the ghost, dude. Stick your middle... No. I'm not going to chastise or fucking... bother ghosts because too many people believe in it. No. I don't believe in it, but I'm not going to go there
if you don't believe
fuck
in it, then
with ghosts.
You got to fuck with them.
Huh?
Then you gotta fuck with them a little bit.
I'm not fucking with ghosts.
Why? You don't believe in it.
Because it's like if I was an atheist, I wouldn't fuck with God.
I would. I am an atheist.
Look what happened.
Come on, we gotta find the perfect place where we spend the fucking night.
I wanna do this.
Patrice is in. I think Bobby Kelly should be in. Dr. Kwaku?
What's his name?
Oh, he wrote Dr. Kwaku.
Dr. Michio
Kaku. See if he'll go.
Yeah, he wouldn't
see
go.
If he'll fucking
that
go.
Guy's a bore, though. See, you want to spend all night with that
fucking guy? Well, if there's some kind of ghost.
Yeah.
These motherfuckers. Look, I'm not going to fuck with ghosts.
This one is great. Kid in the mirror, watch this. The kid in the mirror fucking video. Kid's looking at himself in the mirror. No big fucking deal. Watch this.
What happens?
You'll see. She's just combing her hair in the mirror.
Her hair.
And then
little Asian kid.
Little Asian kid combing her hair. She turns around, but watch the mirror. She's smiling at the camera now, and she's looking down. Her reflection in the mirror.
wait. Her reflection stayed there.
Yeah.
What happened?
Nigga, the TV broke.
I've seen a better one than that. That one's no big deal.
That's it's her reflection.
That's,
oh, I see.
Superimposed on there.
Yeah.
It's not scary. All right,
let me go to genius. Go to, and she's Chinese, which makes it even more questionable.
Yeah.
Let's go to JoJo.
Got some great things.
JoJo.
I don't believe in ghosts, but if there are ghosts, I've seen some crazy shit at this one place near where my parents live. And the nice thing is, my parents own a hunting preserve, so they've got shooting ranges and bike trails and fishing and all that shit, so you can do your redneck shit during the day and get scared as shit at night when you...
You know, when I got... When, yeah.
God bless him.
Won't even acknowledge him. Won't acknowledge that call even
God
happened.
God bless that he has the sense, the ghostly understanding to know that he just made everybody sick.
When me and...
I forgot the... Sorry, I didn't mean to...
It's okay. When me and Melinda got lost in the woods and had to actually sleep in the fucking middle of nowhere in the woods, and it was... rainy,
it's
dark,
called camping,
and foggy.
Yeah.
No, I was laying there, and we're just covered up with one coat, is all we had, and I couldn't shut my eyes. I kept looking out just further than I could see.
Did you think he was going to die?
In the mist. No, it wasn't even about, like, I'm going to die. It was, I am going to see something horrific. I am going to see a ghostly thing that moves without its legs walking. Just kind of like floating over the ground, coming out of the mist at me. And then I would have just fucking dropped dead right there.
And what happened?
Nothing. Woke up in the morning, our feet hurt from walking. And then we found a ranger station.
We woke up, we had ticks. That's what you need to worry about out there is fucking Lyme disease.
Yeah. But that stuff didn't even bother me. It was like, I know if I walk long enough.
Some of these pictures did bother me on the computer that Dan was showing.
Are they?
See, like the one where the guys, the one that peeked through the top of the window.
Yeah, that was scary.
I probably was shitting my drawers.
See, that's the stuff I can't fucking deal with.
But Halloween, see... Looking out the window, right? My thing is, here's what gets me. It's just looking out the window, and you just see, not necessarily paying attention to you, but like somebody doing something fucked up. Like there was a scene in Jeepers Creepers. Remember that?
Yeah.
And you driving by, and this fucker had a dead body in his shoulder, and he sees you see him.
Yeah,
so I'm like, I peek out the window and see a guy who's doing some shit he ain't supposed to be doing. Now he sees me. And now he's coming. He wants to talk
now
to
he's
me.
Coming after
that
you,
fucks me up. Like that fucks me up. But like,
I always think the thing is, I always think I could fucking deal with a situation that involves real people, real life, shit like that.
Because you can kill them,
right? But that fucking ghostly shit, you're powerless. You're powerless to do anything. And regardless if they're even. The sheet over a guy. That's hysterical.
this is a gag on all those videos. Yeah, all right. Fucking. This is really funny.
That is funny.
Making fun of all the fucking ghost videos online. Very good.
Last year I did Comics Come Home.
Yeah.
I no bullshit.
Yeah.
Did Comics Come Home. Stayed in the Liberty Hotel, which used to be the Charles River jailhouse that they built a hotel in. And we just got our puppy. Just got our puppy maybe a month before. We thought something was wrong with the motherfucker. Wouldn't bark, never barked, ever. This hotel, the first time it ever barked, it started barking in the fucking air in this fucking hotel that's supposed to be a haunted old jailhouse.
What happened?
No bullshit. It just started looking around, barking at nothing.
Jesus.
As its first bark.
That is
the creepiest.
Up. That's fucked up.
The creepiest night I ever had in my life. When my grandfather died, he had this armchair that he always sat in. And the weekend of his funeral, I was staying at my grandmom's, and I had to sleep in the room that I slept in when I stayed there when I was a kid.
Yeah.
And I was already creeped out. Like you're at your nana's, and it's like you're in this weird room.
It's creepy anyway. You're right.
Nana's house is creepy.
I woke up in the middle of the night and rolled over, and the house was dead quiet and pitch black. And she had the armchair. She had it moved into the room, and it was directly across from my eye line in the bed. I didn't notice it. And I was just waiting to wake up and see him sitting there. And I couldn't sleep, dude. I couldn't sleep. I was sweating and shit. Oh, it was so freaky. But then I woke up and found a ranger station, and I was fine.
So. Yeah, man, I was fine. I was in Colorado in a hotel that was known as being a haunted hotel. Like, you walked in, and there were pamphlets on the counter about what had happened in this hotel. It was an old fucking hotel in Colorado. And went up into the room, big, wide hallways with these scary fucking haunted mansion type
like The Shining and shit? Disney.
Yeah, exactly. And went into the room and was just, couldn't sleep, had to have the TV on full blast with like fucking, I'm just looking for Seinfeld or something funny so I could watch that shit. I couldn't sleep. Petrified. Nothing happened, didn't see anything, didn't hear anything, but it's just knowing you're in that environment just freaks me out.
When I was a kid and I get freaked out, I would sing the theme to The Cosby Show because I was like, nothing bad can happen while that's going on.
But I just picture Bill Cosby doing this.
What a great scene in a movie. He just get murdered humming The Cosby Show.
But now they would use that in a movie to fucking really get you fucked up.
Everything's okay.
Yeah. Wait a minute. That's season six. He's talking about the first. Nigga, play the first season, you fucking asshole. This nigga's playing season 12 when Theo had his tongue ring.
Yeah, not this Bobby McFerrin version.
Travis, this is all we have. What do you want from me?
There's got to be.
Just play what we got. Let me say hi to Tim in Indiana. Tim?
Yeah, I don't know who it was. Opie or Anthony told a story about when they were younger, they went to a cabin. And a guy was burned in a bed.
Oh, fuck. That's my, I have a, for the sake of the story, a half-sister, and her, one of her relatives died, and she inherited the money. It was this, like, old, really old house way upstate, and he owned those horrific, like, hunting motels where each room was a separate motel, you know what I mean? Back near the woods where the mountain kind of starts. And we go up there. We go up there to clean out the place. We're just kids. And because my sister's going to inherit, you know, this guy's fucking property and whatnot. Mm. And we found out when we got there that he died because he was smoking in his room. And I guess I was 12, so I was old enough to handle this, my dad decided, which is fucked up. And I go into the house to see where the bed used to be. Mm. That was the only thing that didn't have a burn mark was the square in the rug where the bed used to be. And the walls were all just fucking charred and plywood. That's where the guy died. And my dad thought it was the coolest thing for us that we were going to stay up there for fucking free and we'd all have our own motel room. In the woods, basically. We were scared out of our fucking minds. We didn't understand death yet.
Oh, all your dad had to hear up to was motel in the woods. And he should have been like, that's a bad idea.
And he's basically going, you guys pair off, you all get your own fucking room. I'm like, get the fuck out of here. So we ended up, I mean, a large family. There was about 10 of us at the time, all squeezed into one room because we were scared shitless. And my mom said, we're fucking out of here. The next day, she's like, no way. My dad's plan was we were going to hang out there for like a week. It was going to be our big summer vacation.
Nothing is worse than somebody died in the house the way they weren't supposed to. Because that's what it's like. My cousin's ex-girlfriend lived in a house in Jersey. And everybody swore up and down the house was haunted. Me and my cousin didn't believe him at all. And then he told me one night what happened was this lady that lived in the house died of cancer in the house. And it was like a tragic young death kind of thing.
Right.
And he said he didn't believe that the place was haunted. He said one night the parents, him and his girlfriend, everybody that lived there.
Josephine DeRosa?
Yeah, exactly. Kind of like me. That's how they'll be selling my apartment. A man died here, so the rent's a little low. But he said they were all sitting in the living room together watching TV, and upstairs they literally heard like,
"Get the fuck out of here!"
Like stomping on the ceiling.
Get the fuck out of here!
Come on, that's fucked up.
How creepy is that?
Too creepy.
Another quick story. When I was shopping for a place to live in Manhattan, I was going around with a realtor. I told this one too. I was in a brownstone. And they were really anxious to sell this place more than usual. Mm-hmm. And the mom of this family was running ahead of us and straightening up every room, making sure everything was perfect as we're walking through checking out this place. And we got a really weird, creepy vibe. So when we left, we're like, all right. And they're not supposed to tell you, but we're like, all right, what the fuck is the deal? There's obviously something that is weird and not right with that whole family and that fucking brownstone. They're like, well, I'm not supposed to tell you this, so it's between, you know, me and you guys, but their son committed suicide in there, and they really want to sell that fucking place and get the fuck out of there. So now I'm thinking back to, well, where the what spot was it in the house I was just in.
Yeah, and how did he do it, too?
I wanted all the questions now, because the mother of this, you know, son that committed suicide was with us the whole time. So I'm like, there was a point where we're in some part of the house where she knows that's where they found their son.
I can deal with the I took pills to death ghost, but I can't deal with a Pascal from Pet Sematary I blew my head off ghost.
would you buy the Amityville Horror house for cheap?
Hell fucking no. Just in case.
For cheap.
You know, I don't know what I believe, but fuck no.
Nothing's happened in that house. No, even like...
I understand that, but it's your mind that fucks with
you. Yeah, that's what it would be.
That's the problem, whether they're ghosts or not. It's what your fucking mind does.
And I think that's what it is. My heart, I think, is getting weak. So my heart won't allow me...
To have one good scare.
Yeah, and I'm not into, like, because my favorite show, probably my top three shows of all time is Scare Tactics.
I love Scare
Tactics.
Did you believe in that shit?
What, the show?
Yeah.
It's the greatest show.
Oh, wait, which one are we talking about now? Now I'm confused.
Scare Tactics is the one that they create scary scenarios.
Oh, that aren't real.
That aren't real.
Okay, because what about the other one that I kind of liked for a while, where they did do what we were trying to do, where they went to all these haunted places?
Oh, the Ghost Hunters or Ghosts.
No,
it's called, like, Fear Itself. It's still on. That's, I was saying earlier, you should
There was an early version of that, and now they redo the show a lot. But the first one, I think it was on MTV or something.
I'm not an adrenaline junkie, man. People love to be scared and love. Yeah, I'm not into that shit.
No, I don't either.
And never was.
No, I'm not a fan of that.
So set up the fucking haunted house.
Scare tactics.
Or the haunted prison. Let's do it.
I'll do it. I think we'll get some good video.
If Anthony does it, if everybody does it, I'll do it.
I won't be a fan of that.
Bob Kelly would be perfect. Ant would be perfect.
Fucking dude. Patricia, what was that? Good. I heard Joe DeRosa. Dude.
We got a good group.
I don't think you can get Bobby to do it.
No electricity, though, dude. No fucking lights.
And Norton's already shaped like a ghost.
We got flashlights.
A bunch of flashlights, yeah, but we can't have an out where we can just turn some shit on.
Yeah, you got to have the flashlights, because that's the scariest part is when you see a child quivering in the corner somewhere.
I would joke all night long.
That's why I want to do it.
I would laugh all night long.
That's why I want to do it.
Because it's like, why would a ghost... The idea that anything has human emotion is what bothers me, is that... Like, there's aliens up in the sky just going, And there's some fucker who have an alien somewhere in Area 51 who got a gun and he's watching the Area 51. And inside, there's a fucking alien. And he don't tell his wife, or he don't go, fuck that. He's so rigidly trained that he doesn't eat ass. Like, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And the ghost is like... Okay, ready, ghost? Really? Are you being is there one ghost that's not going to stereotype me and peek around the corner and then just disappear?
I'm scared.
Where's the ghost that's going to go, I'm here, man. Listen, I killed myself and my body's stuck.
But that's not how they work.
Well, nigga, can you eat? You know,
but that's not how they
work. Let's talk.
Yeah, there's got to be one that would
take that. What happened to friendly? Yeah, every ghost is a ghost.
Yeah, there's got to be one that would take that angle like this.
The normal ones are the ghosts that go where they're supposed to go and do what they're supposed to do when they're dead. These are fucking like rogue, crazy people. These are like the homeless people you see on the street that talk to themselves.
You
want to
hear?
That's
crazy. Well, why don't they do that right there? And then when you call the cops and say, hey, there's a fucking ghost in my house. He's still there. But ghosts are like the fucking hello my baby frog. That motherfucker does it when I'm looking, then everybody's around.
Hello my honey.
He's dead when everybody else is looking. Get out of here with that shit. That's why I refute it, is because they're not. Why doesn't a ghost just come in and stand right here in front of us?
Don't fucking ask him.
There are theories about it, and this is going to creep you out even more. This is going to creep you out even more, Ed. There are theories with, like, demons, demonic souls, souls cursed to hell, all that shit, that, you know, there are levels to hell. There are, like, 9 levels to hell.
Yeah.
And the demon is more powerful in its... In its home level of hell, whatever you would call it, its natural habitat of hell, it's the most powerful. But as it climbs up the levels, it gets less popular or less powerful. Excuse me. So that would kind of explain where if you're seeing evil ghosts, they can only kind of faintly appear to you here.
But they faintly do faintly shit. Like if they faintly appear, just faintly appear, motherfucker. Don't faintly peek around the corner so I kind of see you. Fuck, come on, man. So the thing is, when they do their thing, and this is the only thing that makes me doubt it. I believe in a lot of things. I do not believe in ghosts. I believe in they exist or spirits, but I don't believe that the little girl from 1812 is still sitting in that corner doing the same creepy shit they was doing in 1812.
They're all fucked up. Like, they don't know what to do.
Yeah, maybe they can't.
They're all like, whoa.
But why does it happen? Anthony, do you see my point, though? I'm like, exactly.
But that's all they do.
Why does the ghost still have a bad chest cold? Like, why does it, you know what? It's the stereotype. It's like you see a fucking ghost that goes boo. Like,
yeah.
Boo. Like, it's a constant creeping you out as opposed to, hey, look, man, what's wrong with you?
It doesn't matter, because if the ghost was like, hi, hey, I just wanted to, I'd be going,
I'd rather believe in Whoopi Goldberg from Ghost. Yeah. In that situation, as Patrick Swayze's like this dude who still has emotions and he's like dead. He's like, hey, help me find my girl. Help me move this penny.
Do you think he's really going to communicate with her now?
But wait, here's the thing, though. It's not like they don't make...
Did you just say that?
Huh. Holy shit, I just caught that. There was no way else to use that shitty joke. But just fucking asshole. I just caught that fucking joke. Joe's an ass. Couldn't wait for a fucking... You thought that joke was over. And you're like, wow. I can use it again.
I just thought of it right now.
Fucking son of a bitch.
That's terrific. We're going to take a quick break. Joe DeRosa is going to be filming a... recording a comedy CD at the Stress Factory tonight and tomorrow.
Yes,
filming
sir.
The whole time, recording the whole time.
Yeah, taping two shows tonight, two tomorrow.
Is it true that fucking Bobo's warming up for you?
Yes, I was supposed to give him a guest spot tonight, but this. I just said that to get the fans to come out. If they're not gonna come in,
welcome.
Well, you have a second down.
He shut up. He's like, I didn't forget you. Like, I didn't forget. It's like, I don't want to stick.
He twittered
kid.
It.
Well, how about this?
Make sure you catch me at Joe DeRosa's show.
How about this? He's here.
Yeah, I know.
How about he auditions?
All right.
He gives you his best 2 minutes. We'll make believe that, you know, it's the Stress Factory. And then he'll do his thing. And if you like it, then he can do it for you at the Stress Factory.
All right.
That's fair enough.
I'm
at least
down
let
with
him
that.
Audition today. He's here. Patrice is going to be at Bananas Comedy Club in Poughkeepsie. So those two shows aren't really competing with each other because they're far enough apart. So see Patrice if
unless
you're north of the city.
Unless some people from the Stress Factory want to just come on down.
Yeah,
somebody got tickets. We'll redeem Stress to Factory tickets.
Two for one. If you got a Stress Factory ticket,
if you have a Stress Factory ticket for tonight, tomorrow,
not only you in, but five of your pals.
That's fucked up. Man. That's some fucked up shit. If a motherfucker did some shit like that,
why would you do that in his final days? That's not nice.
Man, I'm sorry.
It's the
man.
End.
I'm sorry,
the end of
dude.
Days, man.
Just don't die in studio, because I don't want your fucking ghost coming back.
Oh, I would love it, and just Anthony couldn't come in here anymore because he's too scared.
The studio's haunted.
The pessimistic, depressed ghost of Joe DeRosa is haunting the studio.
A lot of people have ghost stories and places we could spend the night. We got to find someone that could get this done for us legally. There's got to be a place.
It's scary.
And the MTV show is called Fear. Thank you for that answer. It came in a million times over the instant feedback. All right, quick break. Opie and Anthony, we'll continue. Full house, Patrice O'Neill and Joe DeRosa in studio. Now, Joe's playing the Stress Factory tonight and tomorrow.
Yeah.
And he got Bobo to do, like, a guest spot, but now you're having second thoughts, I guess, huh, Joe?
I want to have Bobo on. I just don't want it to, you know, I got to record an album, so I just don't want it to be a goddamn pit in the show. If
you
know.
You think it could go wrong? With retarded Bobo and his fucking, his uncontrollable little hog?
Possibly.
Still my favorite video I've done so far. Your fucking reaction to that video, dude, is...
painful.
One for the ages, man.
Which
one
video?
For the fuck? It's too long to get into now.
It's just Bobo, ridiculous to have Bobo on.
We learned that Bobo gets hard very easily when you start talking about broads.
You just gotta talk about a girl.
And it gets rock hard, this little fucking thing he calls a penis. And then you start talking about the Mets, and it instantly goes down.
It goes away, and then you talk about girls again, and it goes back.
So we told Patrice about it, and he saw it for the first time, and a guy's reaction on video, it's just ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's fucking
it was in the top
ridiculous.
It's in the top seven laughs I've ever had.
It's,
that was a good one.
It's an unbelievable thing, the control he's got, just like that.
Telling you after the show on Tuesday, with not Tuesday, but the last time I was here, when Bobo took his dick out and he had the pre-cum dripping out of it.
Yeah. Oh.
That was one of the hardest times I ever laughed in my fucking life.
Yeah,
dude.
His cock has given us a lot of humor, which is...
We've laughed at his dick many times.
I have it on my phone. You, hearing, all you see is Bobo and Danny and E-Rock almost vomiting when he tries to smell his pubes. And then when you...
I forgot about that.
I'm laughing right into the speaker because I'm right next to the phone. And then Anthony's evil laugh like... That starts coming in. And then you hear you punching the fucking console. Dude, it's so funny, man.
That's an amazing
episode. So fucking going funny. On there that
why don't we get Bobo in? He could like at least try out his material, see if it's worthy of you,
man. Shit.
You having on your show at the Stress Factory.
That's fucking genius.
Yeah.
Well, he's opening up for your album that you're going to sell.
Hey, Bobo.
I didn't know it was recorded when we plugged the date last night.
Bobo, your hair grows fast.
Yeah, that's it. It's always
yeah, that's right.
Like that. It grows pretty quick.
What are you wearing? And talking to the mic. You've been on the
if
show.
If you're a cartoon
to...
fan, you have to be a cartoon fan or a comics fan and know that Bobo looks like the Mole Man right now.
The Mole Man.
You have to be a fan of comics. He's the Mole Man right this second. Well, he's just missing his hat and his fucking thing that he has.
Well, for some reason, Sam thought this Sam's idea to wear this here.
What is it?
I don't know. It's when it
looks like a Snuggie.
It's a Snuggie.
No, it's not a Snuggie.
What, Danny?
It's a Slanket.
A Slanket.
But that's,
nice.
That's just a rip-off of a Snuggie.
No, it's not. It's a little
and
different.
And it's a WWE product.
WWE.
Yeah.
Does one of the wrestlers wear this, Danny?
No, it just
you're
gets cold in each arena. In the fucking Quicken Loans arena, it gets freezing.
Yeah. Well, we're not going to spend a lot of time with Bobo, because, quite frankly, it drives the audience nuts. So, but we want to see if he's got material to warm up for Joe DeRosa at Stress Factory tonight.
Yeah, Bobo, here, I want to hear your material, but I'm recording my CD tonight, and I didn't know that last time, so it's got to be a tight show, man.
Well,
so,
if
we can't do it this time, we'll do it next time, but do some material. Let me hear some of your shit before I say, yeah, definitely come down and, you know.
All right, I'll tell you this one. I have to say, I hate these frickin' psychiatric drugs and their stupid side effects.
Wait a minute, you gotta go, right, don't you, everybody?
Yeah, right?
Are you sick of it? Don't you guys hate psychiatric drugs?
Do you guys hate that? I hate those stupid side effects. I was on this one that I had to get taken off right after 2 days. This thing, I couldn't move freaking anything. I'm like so... I couldn't move anything so much. I think... Geez, somebody get me a forklift. I couldn't move anything. They thought, what is this? Is this a guy doing a human statue bit on the subway?
Fuck. Joe,
waiter!
This is perfect for you.
Waiter! Give me two more of these!
Continue, Bobo. Continue.
The whole time I looked like this, and I'm walking around sounding like Tom Menino going... Get the bus change. I'm trying to say that to my sister, and then no one, they're freaking standing, and then I'm calling, and my mother thinking there's nothing wrong with me. They said, Bob, there is something wrong. This medicine is freaking having a horrible side effect, and you damn know well, there's no way I can fix this. I couldn't even move anything. As a matter of fact, it took me like a whole hour to pee.
Oh, shit, he's killing. Joe, this is perfect for you.
Oh, you gotta leave this in the fucking CD, Joe.
Yeah. This is perfect for you, Joe. What do you think, Joe?
I don't know what the fuck he's talking about, but you guys.
It's a psychiatric drug side effect.
Yeah, yeah, what's the fucking, what's the mystery?
It's killing with you guys. So, right, you know, so, can I hear a little bit more? Do we have time to hear?
All right, a little more.
Do you have another subject, Bobo? Maybe another subject aside from psychiatric drugs?
Well, I got the other thing. This annoying $1 guy. $1, $1, $1, $1, $1, $1, $1, $1. I said, let me ask you a question. How much do these batteries that will just go dead in an hour cost?
Dollar store batteries.
I love saying that.
I know what he's saying.
Every time I see that guy selling the batteries on the subway, I say that every time.
What?
Yeah.
How much do those batteries that last only an hour cost?
And he says $1, $1, $1.
Yeah, exactly. That's all he says.
Joe, you gotta have them.
I don't know.
It's not when he does the same material at the Stress Factory. This is famous material now because it's been broadcasted.
This is gold, Jerry.
This is gold.
Joe, this is killing.
It will be great if it's wall-to-wall O&A fans in there. If it's just New Brunswick folk. You know,
it's fucking gonna kill in New Brunswick, folks.
Yeah,
too.
Man. You got anything else? Another subject?
Well, wait, how many minutes do you have? Like, how many?
We usually get like 3 minutes, to 5 minutes.
That's like a 5 minute thing. So I wrote stuff based on that, based on.
You wrote another joke. Let's hear the last joke.
I wrote stuff based on the 5 minute.
How are you
gonna
get out
thing?
To New Brunswick tonight?
I just take the train, a few trains.
Two trains?
Oh, Jesus.
Two trains.
Yeah, just three trains. Just three trains.
What time is the show?
it's around 8 o'clock, but I take...
The pioneers didn't take three trains when they went out to California.
Yeah, we're
he's going to show up. We all didn't make it.
I live in Maspeth. So I have to take a bus to get to the nearest train station.
Uh-huh.
It's one of the few areas in New York City that's not near a train station.
What time are you going to leave?
I'm probably going to have to leave around 5 or so. I'll probably arrive around 6.
You're like when fucking Liza Minnelli went out to Arthur's house for the party.
I gotta walk up. And this is actually true. I gotta walk up to the Q18 bus, take that to 61st Street Woodside.
Oh shit!
Which is by the way a block from where I grew up. By the way,
Bobo, why are you explaining your fucking route? No, I wanna shit.
I
want to
hear it. But then what? Then what are you doing?
I'm fucking enamored right now. I'm into this story about his buses.
Then what do you do?
Not because I'm trying to show you an example of
so how are you gonna get to how you gonna get to the fucking show? The show's at 8 o'clock.
Patrice, meet him at the station, drive him
and
out.
And now the station doesn't
I
drop
got a
you
show,
off
nigga.
Right
I'm a-
station doesn't drop you off right at the comedy club. What do you do after you take all those trains?
Well, I just walk there. It's a short walk.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, it's a short walk.
But what train, how are you, explain from the time you leave your door to the time you get to the comedy club, what's your journey?
Well, I leave the door, head out to a bus, then transfer to the 7, then I got a train... And then I transfer to the 1 to Penn Station.
Yeah.
Then I got to take the New Jersey Transit train up to New Brunswick.
Joe, will you just pick him up? If he's going to do time for your show.
And that's like a block. And that's
Bobo.
Like a,
Joe will pick like, you up tonight.
This is
pick
like,
up Bobo.
It's like a casino and Pesci has to keep switching cars just to drive out to his own jewelry store.
How are you getting a Stress Factory, Joe?
I'm not taking the R7 to the 1 to the West Side Highway or whatever. Yeah, train. I'm going to take a nice train.
So why don't you fucking just meet him?
Yeah, meet Bobo, man. If you guys are working together, you might as well travel together.
You know, I can't.
Why is that, Joe?
Okay, what train? What time is your train that gets you to Stress Factory?
3 o'clock.
Yeah, you're about an hour and a half right before me.
Yeah.
You two should go together. Yeah. Why don't you go together?
I gotta get out there. I gotta do afternoon radio.
You guys gotta work on the show. Make sure it runs smoothly. Bobo, Joe.
So you're gonna have you're gonna have this guy host, then bring up Bobo, then bring up the feature, then you come and do your CD.
What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have the guy host, then the feature, then me, then the show's gonna end.
But Bobo, where was you gonna put Bobo at though?
I think I'm going to do Bobo next time. I don't think this time is
the time. No, he's already, he brought his tickets and stuff, man. Yeah, bumped. Joe, you can't.
Wait,
you can't
Joe, talk
that.
To Bobo. You don't want him performing
tonight? You can't
tonight?
Fucking do that. You can't fucking fire Bobo tonight, man.
We got to have a tight show. I got to record
my
album.
No, you don't
album.
Have a tight. You don't have to have
he's
a tight
tiny,
fucking show.
Yeah, you heard his material. What do you mean?
You don't have to have a tight show.
The problem is I do a lot of material about dollar store batteries.
So what, though? Different content.
I don't want us to step on each other.
Don't fucking fire Bobo tonight.
I'm not fired. Well, I'm saying well, next time
then,
we'll do
then
it.
Then I won't use the dollar store battery bit.
Yeah, there you go.
Ah, say, what, you what
you what's your replacement
look at,
bit?
No,
what's your
replacement don't, bit? Look at, I see what you're doing. You can't fire fucking Bobo, man. Let him work tonight.
Yeah, Bobo.
He bought,
tonight,
he bought
right?
his fucking tickets, yeah. man. Come on, man.
He wants to work tonight, Joe.
I know he does. So
there
do
is
I,
no
though,
next time,
which is
Joe.
Why I need to take him off the show.
The, oh, Jesus.
No, we got to keep it tight, I'm saying.
Well, why you... keep it tight? Shorten up the fucking MC. Shorten up the feature. Let Bobo come in after the MC. And then the feature comes on and gets the crowd, like, fucking calms them down from after Bobo. Yeah. And then brings you on, man. Mm-hmm. Bring Bobo.
I like it.
Hey, Joe, if you don't want Bobo, then you tell him to his face. Stop beating around the bush and saying next time.
Bobo.
This is terrible.
I don't want you tonight.
This is fucking
I want
terrible.
To have you on next time.
No, that's no, a, what's no, the that's difference between next
time? That's a lie.
No,
yeah.
that's not. I swear
that's
to God.
A lie.
I didn't
that's
know
bullshit.
I was recording my CD this
that's
time
bullshit.
When I asked
that's
him
bullshit.
Last time.
That's bullshit.
Look at his fucking face. I don't want to look at him. I don't even want to look at him now.
Tell him the truth.
Fucking kid, man.
Are you sad if we don't do it tonight, man?
Now I have no problem with that. I'll be there Saturday then.
No. I'm saying I got to record tonight right, and Saturday. So let's do it next date that I do there. Is that all right?
All right, no problem. I'll still be in the audience.
Are you though. Upset? Yeah, come. You can still come to the show.
Why
man.
The fuck
you,
would he come
you.
After you fired
yeah,
him?
Yeah. Now I'm still gonna be the audience anyway.
How far are you from Poughkeepsie?
How far am I from...
No, I know what you're trying to do.
I ain't putting Bobo on my fucking show. I didn't promise him nothing.
Yeah, you promised him,
you
Joe.
Promised him, and now you're firing him.
No, I'm not firing him. I'm just saying
Bobo,
I didn't know
you're
I was
being
recording.
Fired.
No. Bobo, I'll do it next time, I promise.
I live out in Queens.
Yeah, this is terrible, man.
Wow.
This is terrible.
Bobo.
He's making me feel bad a little bit.
Yeah it's should. Fucking terrible, dude. Put
Bobo,
him on.
He don't watch you.
What do you got besides the dollar bill thing? Give us one more bit.
Now the other one I don't remember very well. I have that one written down.
Well, just kind of wing it.
Yeah, wing it.
Basic idea.
Let me see. I'm trying to remember.
You just sounded so judgmental and gay. You went, give us one more bit.
Give us one more. Just see if he could do it, Joe. Just see.
I'm literally fucking in pain for Bobo right now to get fired. Right. He gets up in the morning. He was gonna go home. Not probably not even sleep practicing his fucking act for you, and you fucking fire him the day of the show in the morning.
Hey, he's excited, Joe.
Fucking awful, man.
Nothing wrong with that.
And he's going to be there still to support you. Unbelievable.
Bobo, come out. I'll tell you what, man. Come out to the shows. If I can get you on, if I figure it'll work out,
I'll
do it.
You're the boss, Joe.
Oh,
you're the fucking boss.
I know.
You tell Vinny and it's done.
Come out to the shows. If I can get you on, I
what
will.
What the? Joe.
I'm not gonna
Joe.
I can't promise.
Huh? You can get him on. You saying come out there, and if you're feeling fucking, omnipotent and benevolent, you'll put him on. You fucking asshole.
The end. Joe's an asshole.
Fucking dick.
Damn.
You know. I'm sorry. All right, let's do it.
Oh, wait a minute. I got another one.
One more bit.
Okay, he's got another one.
I got another one.
Go ahead.
What do you mean you got another one?
I got another one about the bus announcements.
Okay.
I noticed that. I noticed I'm on the bus recently. They've got these digital announcements.
Yeah.
And do they really need the digital announcements? They got a guy in driving the bus who you can hear pretty clear. He's out in the open. He's not in some kind of booth or something. You can hear the guy.
Yeah.
You need a useless digital announcement. And these new ones freaking annoy me. Please exit through the back door. And then you press the button and it says, the door is now closing. Gee, I already know that. I don't.
Right?
I don't.
What makes him not deserve to go on?
I don't need an announcement.
He fucking deserves.
What the fuck, Joe? He just
minute,
proved
Bobo.
Himself right there.
He fucking deserves.
He just proved himself.
He deserves some of your fucking time after that.
That's right, man.
Are you fucking serious, Joe?
Oh, Jesus.
That fucking bus stuff, that material?
I killed.
It's good stuff.
Wait a minute. The fucking hour long dead dollar battery bit didn't move you enough to put him on stage? You promised the guy, man.
Mr. Bobo, we've got your tape. We listened to it. Jerry's very interested. And we'll be getting back to you.
And then he's going to still... He didn't even offer Bobo, like, a fucking at least a VIP apology.
I said I'll take care of him tonight if he comes out to the show. If I can get him on, I will. I'll comp his tickets
Stop
and all that shit.
If you can get him on.
Shallow promises.
That's what he wants.
This is what I'm saying.
Joe DeRosa, the king of the shallow promise.
You see how he makes big, like, I'm sure promises, yeah. But then there's one that he goes... I'll see if I can do it. He's like, hey, I'll comp you a steak, a fucking VIP.
No, I didn't say steak.
And then,
because he'd rather have charity than fucking be on stage.
Right. Yeah, going after his dream. You can help his fucking dream.
Joe, very disappointing.
You're a dream snatcher.
I'm disappointed in all of us this morning.
Who let you get up on stage?
Tell him.
What comic let you get up on stage?
Tell him.
That was Voss.
Rich Voss.
Rich Voss, the great Rich
He's
Voss.
He's confident enough.
He has
in
a
his
heart.
Material.
Joe doesn't.
Rich Voss is confident enough in his act that he was able to have Bobo open up for him without saying, how am I going to follow that? You know?
Yeah, I know. It's tough.
And Vinny's bringing on Bobo.
That's
Vinny's
right.
Bringing on Bobo. Let's
Vinny supports fucking Bobo.
Let's hear this. We should listen a little of the actual.
So you know him as a regular performer on the Opie and Anthony radio show, all the way from Queens.
This is what you're going to miss, Joe.
A loud, warm, stress factory welcome to my good friend Bobo. Let him hear it.
Listen to that. Bobo hits the stage, high fiving people like a retard.
I got it. Bobo got it.
In New Jersey.
Hear that.
But first of all, how many here screwed over a stockholder to come here tonight? I watch CNN. I know what's been going on. Well, first I'd like to introduce to you. You know him from the Opie and Anthony show.
Did he say first?
Yeah.
Could you read?
That is great.
You missed his name. Jersey Zone, Rich Voss.
Here's what I love about Bobo. He understood that he bombed.
And he
had the chops.
That's right.
To fucking move it along, man.
Let's go.
What happened was I didn't know how much time they gave me. So that time I made it a little bit shorter.
And he respects the light. This guy is a professional.
I think I added a little bit more to that the second time when I did the second show that night.
Oh, did ya?
All right, I'll tell you. Because
you guys are missing
some good stuff.
How many here screwed over a stockholder to come here tonight?
What was a different audience?
CNN, I know what's been going on. Well, first I'd like to introduce you. You know him from the Opie and Anthony show. He's the Jew with the right amount of stupidity and the horse of a smile. Give it up for New Jersey's own Rich Voss.
The horse of a smile?
No, I meant I screwed up the line. I said the smile of a horse.
Yeah, you said the horse of a smile.
See, Rich did it.
As a regular, you know him.
And this is for the late show.
Now he's going to rip.
Put your hands together for the one and only Bobo, everybody.
He goes longer. For the late show.
Look at the people, love him.
Oh, he changed his clothes.
New Jersey! All right, who's here from Queens? Who do we got here from Queens? Oh, we got my relatives here. We got my cousin, Mikey, who's from Queens, who grew up in the same neighborhood as me. He's now in Smith Temple Violet. He managed to make it out here from the city LAE traffic, along with, let's see, we got here my Aunt Sarah. And my uncle Willie from Flushing, he made it out of your shitty traffic on the LIE. Believe me, it's shitty. Though you don't go to Long Island Expressway, it's very shitty. The traffic, I mean.
Bobo's very distinguished.
Who screwed over a stockholder? Oh, we got one that screwed over a stockholder. I think you're probably going to end up having to get that anal rape by Bernie Madoff. Who here's from Jersey? He's got an interesting job. Let me see.
You can't use that tonight. You can't fucking use his energy. You're an asshole, Joe. Jesus, this makes me forget how to do comedy. Like I'm getting nervous about my show tonight. Like, I'm like, fuck me.
You guys have made four guns of gonna rock it. Beat from Jersey. Whoa.
All right, Bobo.
Give it up for the guy who has the right amount of stupidity and has a horse-like smile.
See, he writes material, Joe. He doesn't just go up there and wing it.
He writes
material.
It's like when you get hired to do a corporate. He writes for the people in the room.
Do you want me
to
go to the phones and see what the listeners think?
Oh, wow. I'll be shocked to hear their opinion on this.
What are you talking about, Joe? We're live. You don't set up phone calls here on this show. Let's go to Jeff in Rochester. Jeff.
Yeah, good morning, boys.
Hey.
Bobo, fuck Joe. I got 8 tickets. You can have them all and bring 7 of your finest friends with you tonight.
All right. Thank you. Let's go to Jeremy in Jersey. Jeremy?
Good evening.
Hey, Jeremy.
Hey, Joe, man. We got like 7 tickets between me and the guys I work with. If you don't put Bobo on, man, we're not fucking coming.
Oh, shit. Say hi to Rob in Jersey. Rob.
Yeah, see, Joe, if you don't let him go on, I got 12 people going, you're going to have 8 tickets.
Oh, man. People are dumping their tickets.
Steve in Jersey. Steve.
Joe, don't be a selfish goose. Did you hear that bus bit? I pissed my pants.
Hey, guy's pissing his pants.
All right, let's go to Bill in Jersey. A lot of Jersey calls coming in. Bill.
Hey, Joe, I just want to tell you that I got 4 tickets, and I'm going to bring colors if you don't let them on.
Let's go to Kevin in Rhode Island.
Oh,
Kevin.
Shit.
Hey, guys. Hey, Joe, man, I got 2 tickets. My wife and I were going to head out over there tonight. But I'll tell you what, you can have them. Thanks.
You're going to have a what?
You basically need at this point to put Bobo on that stage.
How did they all know to do the same thing?
What are you talking about?
Like, how did they all know to call up and go, I got this many tickets, we're going to bail, I got
serious.
This many tickets?
Because they're serious.
They ain't
you can't set
around.
That shit up.
They ain't fucking around.
We didn't set nothing up. That's just people talking,
all right,
Joe.
Bobo, come out tonight. And I'll do the thing that you did for Voss. Introduce me. Bring me on for one of the shows.
Yeah, but he has to do his material.
He's got
to
do like a couple
of jokes. You saw
it.
It's like 2 minutes.
Well, I'm just going to do one of the things. I'm going to do the psychiatric drug bit.
Yeah, that's a good one. That's good.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah, that's like
that one.
You got to admit that's like Woody Allen's moose bit.
That's his
brilliant.
Fucking benchmark.
That's his benchmark bit. That's like the 7 dirty words, Joe.
That's the fucking
that's his go-to bit.
That's Kevin Meanies, we are the world.
Joe, agree? You're kind of in a bad spot here, Joe. I'm telling you.
I seriously,
our listeners are vicious.
They can Bob be Nelson's juggling handkerchief.
Bob Nelson's Jiffy Jeff.
Jim. Well, hold on.
Fucking football player.
Let's go to Hydro, because Joe's still not sure. Hydro?
Yeah, this is Hydro from North Carolina. I got 7 tickets, and Bobo better be on stage, or I ain't coming, nigga.
Let's go to Brooklyn A's. Brooklyn A's.
Oh, my brother's bachelor party tonight. We were going to the show with 25 of his friends. No Bobo, no go. Just this in is city bar earlier.
Joe, let's
it's like that I Love Lucy episode. Ricky Ricardo will not be performing tonight. I canceled the tickets.
Oh my god! Joe, you're in the middle of a hostage negotiation right now. Let's be honest with each other. So let's work this out.
Oh, you guys,
you got a major problem on your hands.
You guys railroaded me.
Oh, I'm gonna be representing Bobo. Bobo will introduce you.
People gonna be like, we want Bobo.
You want the early
we
show
want
or the late
Bobo.
Show? We gotta negotiate here. We'll allow you to pick which show, early or late?
Early, because I don't need any fuel added to the fire on the late show.
You're recording all 4 shows. Don't worry about it. You'll get enough material. So he'll intro you.
Thank
early
you.
Show tonight at the Stress Factory.
Yeah, intro.
And you're recording your fucking CD.
Yeah, you can.
And what joke? Let's negotiate the joke. 2 jokes. He's got 4, so you got to let him do 2.
Let him do half.
Okay, do
that.
2 jokes.
Which one do you want? The dollar one's a good strong bit, too.
The 2 jokes of your choosing.
Which one do you want, Bobo?
No, I'm saying I want to give him carte blanche. He can do whatever 2 jokes he wants.
Which one do you want?
Well, I'm going to do the one about the psychiatric drug.
Yeah, that's a brilliant one.
And then the other one, since I know you were doing a thing about the dollar battery guy, I'm gonna do the thing about the new bus announcements.
Yeah, the bus announcement's pretty strong too.
What do you think you'll close with? Because you want to close with the strongest one. What do you think is strongest?
Welcome to the show, Joe.
Welcome. I've been coming in for 6 months.
I know, but this is when it becomes official. We've been hazed.
I'll close with the psychiatric drug bit.
I forgot. Why contribute to the radio show? The name's only on the fucking billboard, Bobo.
Can we call Vinnie Brand and see if he's cool with it?
If you know anything about fraternities, we've been hazing you for a long time. This is your hell night. You get past this, you're fucking in. You're one of the guys.
I think of it more like a prospect biker gang guy finally getting his patch for the back of his jacket.
Right.
I think of it more like I'm already like raped and almost dead, like in Casualties of War, and you want to go for one last fucking ass pump. That's how I see it.
All right, so we're on the same. So we're basically on the same page, Joe.
Bobo, seriously, come out. You introduce me. I don't give a shit. Go ahead, do it. But, you know.
Just make sure there's a big buffer between Bobo and you.
No, it'll be fun. Look, for the ONA guys that are out there, they'll get a kick out of it.
You saw him kill on that fucking Voss tape. Yeah. Come on.
For all the people that called up pretending like they were coming to the show just to get in my head, they'll get a kick out of it. Good for them.
I'm sick of Joe. I don't like how you're treating Bobo, man. This motherfucker's working hard, dude.
Yeah, I'm saying he can come out and introduce me. What else do you want from
writing
me?
Writing shit and everything. He's actually taking this seriously. If some guy was just fucking around going, yeah, I'll come up there, I'll just play.
All right, good.
And you could do that, whatever two jokes you want. I don't care. No. I would never tell an opener... Somebody opening for me what jokes they can do. That's not cool. I would never
Bobo,
do that.
You know what? You're like an artist, man. When you're up there, then you'll decide. That's what you should do.
Or maybe riff a little.
Yeah. Do some crowd work, too. Joe loves that. Yeah, Joe loves when you do crowd work.
Let's do some crowd work. Work on your crowd work now, Bobo. Work the crowd.
Listen to me introducing the crowd around.
Oh, no. You want Sam and... you got to work the actual crowd.
Yeah, you got to work the crowd. What do you do for a living? And then you do something funny on the guy's job or something like that. It's, thinking on your feet right off the cuff.
Yeah, let's see your crowd work there, Bobo.
All right, so I'll say... All right, first I'll like intro. I'll say like good evening, whenever, and I'll say so what do you guys what do one of you guys do for a living?
I'm a comic.
No, give him something that really might happen.
You just fucking threw him so bad.
Say a real job.
Say a real job there, please. That's true.
I do construction, man. Actually, Bubba, you should really look at a person and ask them what they do, not who does something.
Yeah. Look at Patrice and say, "What do you do for a living?"
Right, so you, sir, you're the guy wearing the gold chain. What is it?
I do construction.
Oh, you do construction. So what is it? Has anything ever felt? Anything's falling on you while you're eating fast food during lunch break?
Oh, shit! This is going well. All right, move on to Joe DeRosa. Make sure Joe's a customer.
That was actually better than anything I could think of.
That was actually one of the best fucking insult lines I've ever heard.
All right,
has anything dropped on me while I was eating fast food at my fucking... At my imaginary construction job.
I like this.
You son of a bitch, you.
All right, move on to Joe DeRosa. Make believe he's in the audience.
Wait, so what about you, sir?
How you doing, man?
So what do you do for a living?
I'm an accountant.
Oh, you're an accountant. So any mistakes you made, you...
Come on, Bobo!
Any mistakes that do people just go when you're an accountant, they just call other Christ killer in the background?
Jesus Christ. Oh, you went right for the Jew joke.
No, he didn't go right for it.
He took a minute. Bobo, do that again, please.
I want to hold on. I want to get you, Bobo, doing crowd work to me directly.
So you're an accountant. Help.
No, wait. Ask me again.
How many people have uttered Christ killer during the times they've asked your services?
Ask him what he does for a living. Start all over again.
So you, sir, what is it you do for a living?
I'm a chef.
Oh, you're a chef. Ever accidentally caught your ever burnt your hand?
Yeah, I did once.
Yeah, I could imagine you probably walked in. They all got scared walking there with your hand. That injured hand.
Who got scared?
No, and everybody that walked in saw that burn.
In the kitchen? Like the workers in the kitchen?
No, I'm talking about out in the street.
What are you talking about?
No, I was talking about the burn on your hand.
That people got scared in the street with it?
Yeah, that you go to a guy and you probably went somewhere and you had to hand the guy the cash and they saw that burnt on your hand. They got so scared.
How would they react? How would you react if you saw a burnt hand?
Well, I'd ask, like, what? How'd you get that?
I'm just trying. I'm throwing shit back at you. You got to be ready. Sometimes the crowd talks back to you.
Yeah, they talk back. That's all. You got to shut them down, Bobo.
Will you do Anthony?
Yeah.
You got to get a good one. You, sir, you in the 5'11 gear. What is it you do for a living?
I'm an auto mechanic.
Or you're an auto mechanic. How close have you come to a car dropping on your foot?
Never. We have a lot of safety in place that wouldn't happen, sir.
How long do you stall in a repair job for people that are getting their car fixed by you?
How long have I stalled a...
stalled on a job.
Oh, stalled on a job? We're very reputable. Very reputable.
This fucking audience doesn't know what it's in for. This guy is stingingly quick.
Joe, this is going to be great. Definite crowd work, too.
Come on, you never...
This is Bobo Rickles, nigga. Don't play games with him.
You never left anything in a car that just someone that you just know, your car, like someone that just really bothered you? You noticed it was their car and left anything?
This is not an interview, Bobo. You're fucking making up funny shit, not.
Yeah, all right. Well,
his crowd work is pretty good. He's going to do crowd work. All
right, one more thing that's a little different. Say, hey, anybody here married?
Anybody here married?
Yeah,
I'm married.
Are you, sir? I hope you have a checkbook ready.
Shit! Your gold-digging ass wife.
Damn. Yes, I've been married 32 happy years.
At 32 years in this country, you're gonna have to have a checkbook ready at some point, and a lawyer and a check ready for a law and a lawyer on the speed dial.
God,
come on, Joe.
I'm married with kids. I have kids.
Oh, and you might need two lawyers.
All right. This motherfucker's Tommy gun fast, baby.
And in the audience, Bobo, this guy used to be married, but he's divorced now.
Oh, yeah.
What happened? You're losing more money than Obama's tax plan?
Whoa. Jokes, too. Wow, he's on fire.
This is not just a guy with a moving dick. This guy's
got some shit.
Fast.
I like it. All
right. Put him right on the fucking CD, Joe. What are you waiting for?
He's gonna...
He's prodigy-like with his quickness.
Hole any deeper, please.
It could be one of those like hidden tracks.
You gotta
How
be
cool
committing
would that be?
To having him on the CD.
Everyone thinks your CD's over. Next thing you know, that fucking all of a sudden Bobo pops out.
And Bobo, what's your comedy name? Your stage name?
Well, I use mostly the name Daniel Bobo Curland.
Curland?
That's my real name, Daniel Curland.
Daniel. How you spell your last name?
K-U-R-L-A-N.
Curland.
Bobo.
Curland.
They're calling you.
Why do people like Bobo have the exact names that they should have? Like, it's just his name is Daniel Curland, and it just looks like a fucking idiotic Curland.
And they've actually spelled my name wrong numerous times over the years.
Why?
I don't know why. For some reason, it's just one of those names that people can spell.
How the fuck would you spell it?
Well, they've at my high school.
What do
year,
they do? Is either the only way you can make that mistake is with a C instead of a K, right?
Well, I've seen most of the time I see the C or my personal favorite. When I graduated elementary school, they added an O to my name.
Curlund.
No, it was like, I think I read it like Curlin O.
Curlando?
Maybe they mixed the Bobo up.
Maybe
you should go by Bolando.
Back then, my sister wasn't even born.
Tony Bolando.
My sister wasn't born yet back then.
You sure that was a letter? Not your grade point, Harris?
No, Tony
he answers it like it's a real question. Jesus
he graduated
Christ.
With an O. Average.
And Bobo, they're calling you Bobo Hicks on Instant Feedback.
Yeah.
And you know what? Joe's a big fan of Bill Hicks.
Bobo Hicks.
Bobo Hicks. Fucking topical.
Bobo wow. Bruce.
I'll tell you what they did in my high school yearbook. They spelled my name K-U-R-L-I-N.
Oh, shit.
And they misspelled my high school yearbook.
You haven't gotten
they misspelled
over
my
that
last
one,
name.
I'm sure.
He remembered some fucking shitty thing they did to his name when he was in fucking elementary school.
I couldn't even name one of my high school teachers at this point. Hey, Danny put up a thing up there. I don't know if this is going to work, but we have someone else that should be warming up for you tonight, Joe. And I'm not sure if he's willing to come out of retirement or not. Uh-oh. Is the virus willing to come out of retirement today?
Oh, I hope so.
Have you ever heard the virus?
No.
He's the another virus is really funny.
I don't know if he's willing to do this.
Who's the virus?
The virus broke his hand over this bit, so I'm not really sure if he wants to come out of retirement.
The virus doesn't really like being the virus.
This guy still rings in my head.
Oh, shit.
Oh, man, this guy, now he's bad-mouthing other comics.
We're all looking down the long hallway hoping that the virus would do the right thing and come out of retirement. Sam's trying to pep him up, but I don't know if this is going to happen today. The virus is terrific.
Does he work here or something?
Tell the fucking virus to get his fat ass down here.
The catchphrase for the virus is, we're looking for one punchline. Just one.
Where's he going?
We're looking for one punchline.
That's it.
We're all looking down the hall. I don't know.
Where is he supposed to be going?
Sam has his arms up in the air.
Where's Larry David walking down the hallway, too?
Oh, shit. They're chanting virus on Instant Feedback. Virus. Virus.
Well, let's hear it, man.
Well, I don't know. Sam's not the virus. So Sam's coming in to give us the bad news.
What's going on with
Sam?
Him?
What's up with the virus today?
I think he's trying to big shot you guys. He says he doesn't want to perform. I don't know why he wouldn't want to perform, though.
I think the virus is having trouble getting up.
The
virus needs a forklift.
Oh! Holy shit. Hey, holy shit.
I hope E-Rock knows that was only a joke I was making about him.
No, you weren't.
Oh, the virus is E-Rock?
No,
oh,
the virus is the virus.
Oh, god damn it. Did I just... Bobo blew it first. Yeah. Sorry. Yeah,
no,
Bobo
the virus is blow. The virus. Hey, Bobo.
Come on, Bobo.
Bobo, there's a guy in a wheelchair in the front row. Crowd work.
How do you handle
that situation? Because you still got to be a comic, but you don't want to like get too crazy, right?
Fine line.
Make believe Joe's in a wheelchair.
Yeah.
So he will be soon anyway. If he continues to lose weight.
You're on a wheelchair, man. I feel sorry for you. I feel sorry for the guy that has to give you sponge baths every day.
Why would you say that? That's very hurtful.
No, because I know he's probably home. He might be homophobic.
You're a faggot in a wheelchair.
I didn't say you're a faggot.
You're a wheelchair faggot.
I was trying to hang in the crippled character.
I didn't say that the guy in the wheelchair was a faggot. I meant how some people might be get. I'm sure a lot of people that have to give another guy a sponge bath for a living. Probably.
It's hilarious that he went there. Why don't you talk about his colostomy bag, too, fucking
Bobo?
Probably
feel homophobic having to give another guy a sponge bath.
He went right to the fact that you can't wash yourself.
Believe me, I remember my uncle never got over that sight the first time he had... My uncle used to be one of those... home health aides.
Yeah.
And he says that was the annoying part of the job, was having to do that. You know, having to give another guy a sponge bath.
You know what I just figured out with Bobo? I always thought that there was he didn't have the thoughts. But I realized it's the opposite. It's like the beautiful mind. He can't get to the thoughts fast enough.
This fucker.
The shit is flying through his goddamn head.
I'm telling you, he's semi-genius. I have a new respect for Bobo. It's just that there's a retarded thing that's fighting. There's a war in his mind. There's something retarded and something genius fighting. And the retarded thing is trying to keep the genius from getting out. Yeah.
He's
as
quick as a fucking... He's of sound mind.
So you're going to be very happy by this tonight.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
You just need
Bobo
like,
will be on that stage tonight at the Stress Factory when Joe DeRosa records the CD. Are we going to try to get the virus? Are they trying to get him again? What's up, Danny? No? It ain't happening today?
Bobo needs like
the virus doesn't like performing
thing of electroshock therapy, I bet, to kill the retarded part. And
dude,
then he'd be a genius.
He's a fucking... He's like Sigmund Freud.
He's smiling. He knows it. Bobo, you know you're a genius, right?
Yeah, I know that. Believe me, there's a reason why I aced probably everything except for the math regions the first time.
You want to see how much of a genius he is?
Sam,
we're going to show everyone how much of a genius is. It's time for Bobo Spelling Bee.
Yes.
Bobo Spelling Bee. We're going to show his genius.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
Bobo Spelling Bee.
Well, this one I'm not so good at. I depend on spell check.
Well, no, you do all right, though.
Sam, if you can spell Curland.
Yeah.
You can spell
Curland. Of course I can spell my own last name.
You can spell Daniel Curland.
Patrice, do we have an update on the virus?
The virus, he won't even sit in his chair because I tried pulling his chair to the studio. And now he's standing up in the office. He's got Bobo jokes. He's insulting Bobo in the office.
Really?
So why doesn't he come in and just insult Bobo as the virus? That could be good.
That's what I told him, and Rob Cross, his boss, is down there telling
him. That's brilliant. Yeah, the virus comes in to insult Bobo as the virus. Let's get that done. In the meantime, Patrice, give Bobo a word to spell. This is just amazing. Don't get too crazy with the words. Something that we all know.
Laboratory.
Oh, that's an easy one. That's Jesus, Patrice, perfect. Perfect. Perfect level of spelling right there.
Yes, that's a good one.
Did you say laboratory or lavatory?
Laboratory.
Like bathroom?
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh. You got it, Bobo?
Jesus.
Oh, yeah, you got it.
Yeah, he's got it.
No, lavatory like bathroom. Is that it? Okay.
All right.
The fuck is
all right,
that
Sam's
scribble?
Got it. Sam, why don't you tell us what he spelled.
How do you spell lavatory?
After repeating lavatory several times, he spelled it L-A-B-R-A-T-O-R-Y.
Fuck!
That's laboratory or laboratory.
Jesus, Bobo, I thought you said you didn't know how to spell.
All some right. things I do, some
yeah,
things
yeah,
I don't.
Yeah, that one is perfect.
All right, I got a word for you.
Mm-hmm.
Executive.
Oh, okay, fuck. Okay. Executive, yes. We deal with them every day.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right.
And he's left-handed, too, which makes him...
Yeah, southpaw.
Yeah.
Quick.
What do you mean he's left-handed?
Yeah, hurry.
Oh.
Come on.
Okay.
All right.
Am I retarded? I'm retarded.
I think you might have switched hands.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I swear to God, I thought he was...
Right-handed.
All right.
Exactly. I've always been...
All right, we don't need an answer.
Okay, here we go.
Executive. All right. Executive.
Executive.
Okay.
E-X... C E X C T I V.
There you go.
Oh wow!
Sam's laughing because he can't believe you got that one.
Yeah, this is blowing up in all our faces.
That's a tough one.
Hey, Marcel from Rhode Island. There's a woman with a cancer wig in the front row, Bobo. Going back to that improv, working the crowd. How do you deal with that? Woman with a cancer wig in the front row.
Hey, you, sir. That looks like a wig.
We said woman. You fuck.
But that's the joke.
Yeah, because she's
you,
ugly
sir.
As all fuck.
Right,
yeah, he
right.
knew what he was doing.
I'll
right, be Jesus.
I'm stupid. I'm sorry. Because they want to be, like, you know, they're part of the crowd.
He started with an insult. I liked it. Hey, buddy.
Hey, pal.
Man, I feel sorry for you. How many people get blinded when you fall, when you, if you ever slip?
Yeah.
Slip. No, that's just amazing.
This is next level. That means the wig flies off, because you know those cancer wigs are hard. That's the thing. See, he has all the shit we should know. Cancer wigs are very dangerous if they fly off.
This is next level comedy. This is poetry and
really
metaphor.
See, Joe,
I think that whole thing was about the blinded when they see the bald head.
Bobo's.
Oh, they get all shocked. See? Like, what the?
See, he takes it to another level.
Two levels.
Bobo's two levels
above just the idea of the wig, the dangerous wig.
Yeah.
Fuck me.
Bobo's jokes sound like Dylan lyrics.
Why don't we get another word for Bobo? Joe, you got a word for Bobo to spell?
Yep. Factory.
Factory. That's
factory.
That might be too easy for
as
Bobo.
As in the stress factory.
Yes.
All right.
Very good.
Very smart.
So you might know how to...
Yeah, I mean,
what, is your head getting too
that
skinny
one was
for
too easy. That one was too easy, Joe.
That was too
slipped
easy,
off.
Oh.
There you go.
Way to wreck our spelling bit, Joe.
How about Roosevelt? Right.
Hello.
No.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
Ah, beautiful.
Ah, beautiful, right.
This one you might get lucky. Old man might get this one wrong.
Oh, no. We know you could squeak these out. Hurry, faster.
Yeah, please, you got to do it real quick.
Are you Daniel Curlin of the Queen's Curlin?
All right, here we go. Beautiful.
Right, beautiful. Sam. And in record time, too. B-U-T-I-F-E.
Absolutely.
Fucking A, buddy.
Who needs those pesky two other vowels?
I rushed through that one.
That's how it should be spelled.
I don't need that spell check anymore. And listen, Bobo, there's a Muslim in the front row. How do you deal with that?
Oh, Muslim.
But throw it at Patrice. Patrice is the Muslim.
They
so go.
Patrice
is you, sir. And I feel sorry for you. You probably get stuck 2 hours... 2 hours extra at the metal detector.
No! Oh, is it because I'm Muslim or fat?
Or black?
It's so many levels to that.
He hit you a three. That was a threefold.
Yes. Hit him again.
Two hours at the metal detector. I could imagine you probably have to carry your own rape kit with you in your luggage.
What the hoota? What the fuckity hooty?
Muslims known
though.
As rapists?
No, I was talking about the security guard at the metal detector.
No!
Believe me, I'm sure there's some security guards out there that probably take advantage of their job.
I want to ask you a question. What's in a rape kit?
I have no idea what the heck is in a rape kit besides stuff that I guess used to recover
to rape, lady. It's stuff that rapes.
You use the rape kit to rape.
I think it's to recover deep.
Hey, yeah, lady.
I think it's to recover DNA from, proof.
Bobo, I want to show you how good you are. Ready for this one? Now listen closely.
Yeah.
Bobo's great.
Bobo is in the front row.
Oh, wow.
Oh, shit.
Oh, wait.
This is a challenge.
Malfunction.
Right here.
Danger. Listen.
Bobo is in the front row.
His ears are going to start smoking like when Kirk pulls that double shit on the robots.
Make believe Danny is Bobo. Bobo's in the front row.
If I am here and you are not, then I could not possibly be. Overload.
Bobo's in the front row.
Oh, my God. Look at it. He stopped.
Yeah.
He stopped functioning.
And I feel sorry for you. You probably have to deal with the... getting raped by your brother jokes every time you walk down Grand Avenue.
No, I'm not lying. Yeah, that's right.
What are you gonna do?
Bubba, you was raped by your brother?
No.
They think I was because I missed.
He doesn't like talking about Patrice. Don't bring it up.
They think I missed.
Don't bring it up.
They misheard something I said. And thought I said
you was raped by another Curlin.
No, that never happened.
Joe DeRosa's all the
time. I'm not lying. That never happened.
Bad about this. He started adjusting papers like an anchor man. What
are you
doing?
It's straight up this area.
Bobo, what is your brother's older than you?
That never happened. What happened was during a day that he was in town, right? They misheard.
He just came into town, raped his brother.
No. They misheard something I said.
During the day he was in town, he raped me, see?
What did they mishear? You got that my brother raped me? What could they have confused?
I didn't say that. I think they misheard something say that this is the first time I had seen my brother in years.
No.
You said something
They confuse I was raped by my brother, something curling,
you said
with having seen him in years?
Remember when you said something happened?
Rape.
They thought I said I was. They thought I said he raped me and I was in tears. They got it all fucked up.
No, what I said is allegedly.
Something happened.
He raped me.
I said allegedly.
But he could have, right?
Yeah, that's right.
That, I do not know if that happened.
See, you don't know.
So you don't know for sure.
Your brother got you. Might be
the, no, that never happened. No,
it might be the psych meds you're on. You're not really sure what.
I'm pretty much sure.
Your brother put his pee-pee in your hiney.
No, I'm sure that never happened.
No, you don't know.
And you're ghoulie.
I'm sure it never happened.
I thought you blew him.
No, yeah. That never happened either.
You sucked off your brother.
No, I never did.
Yes, did.
Do you know for sure?
I never did.
Bobo, do you know for sure, though, for real?
I would know.
Would you?
No. Would you, though?
No.
I would know.
You sure?
Oh, my God.
You forget a lot of it.
Jesus Christ.
I think the only
thing... Bobo just made Patrice do the Jackie Gleason Ralph Cramden.
I think there's only one thing I... There's only one thing I'm
face. What?
There's only one thing I'm sure I've done in my sleep, and I've talked in my sleep before. Yeah. I've seen people try to talk.
While you was talking in your sleep, was you chewing a piece of bubble gum that wasn't quite down into bubble gum?
No, I've seen people try to.
I had a dream I was eating manicotti.
I said other people in my household have tried to talk to me in my sleep.
Yeah.
When they know I might not remember it.
Yeah.
Even though there have been a lot of times I have remembered.
So do you remember while you were sleeping and talking to sleep, your brother whispering in your ear, I'm raping you.
I don't think that ever happened.
What does it taste like?
You don't sound sure.
I don't even know what that tastes like.
Can we get the virus down here to heck
yeah,
of
yeah, blah, blah. Get that go fucking check. Virus come on. Down
hey,
here.
Go ahead. I don't mind people heckling me.
Oh,
I like it. Bobo is confident as fuck. I'm telling you, he's regal with his robe and his curlingness.
Are you gonna wear that?
What's your family crest? Just a fucking guy with slobber coming out of his mouth and a fucking shield. I realize he's raping his brother. A rape. A guy with a sword raping his brother.
I don't even know.
With a falcon on his arm. He's wearing. Like Lady Hawk?
Falcon, a sword, and fucking Bobo.
I just realized, I kept looking at that robe going, where the fuck do I know that robe from? It's the robe that Spock wears when he comes back to life at the end of part 3.
Yeah, look at you.
Your name is Opie. You were my friend.
Oh, I love Bobo.
Bobo, you gotta wear that on stage tonight.
The needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few or the one.
Joe, you don't mind if he wears that tonight.
You have to fucking wear
you
that.
You have to
that's
wear
a
that
stipulation.
Tonight on stage.
I have been and always will be your friend.
Jim, your name is Jim.
Bobo.
Actually, that's kind of funny.
When I was a little kid, one of
my uncles used to call, you used to say I looked like Spock when I was little.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, really?
Yeah, one of my uncles used to say that because of the ears I had. I don't think they're noticeable now, but when I was little, they really looked like they stuck out.
And what did you do? Cut them off like Chopper from?
No. I guess my face somehow my face kind of grew in a way that it doesn't really that it kind of blended in.
Fucking it's kinda
I can't believe I was against having him on the show at one point. This guy is genius, man.
Yeah.
I gotta see if I can dig out a really old picture of me.
Yeah, we can't wait to see that.
Actually, but yeah, I'll dig out a really old picture of me. I'll dig out a picture. Wait a minute, I think I got a good one that's at home. A picture of me there was a picture of me on the field. On the field next to one of the Met players from a few years ago. About 23 years ago.
All right, listen.
I'm going to dig out a picture of a 4-year-old me.
Bobo, let me take control a little bit here. We got to take a break. Joe DeRosa is going to be at the Stress Factory. I think everyone knows now. See what we do for you, Joe?
Thank you, buddy.
Recording a CD with Bobo. Bobo's going to warm up for Joe. Definitely in the early show. If it goes well and Joe's a little more comfortable, you might see him at the late show, too. But that's really up
and
to
we
you
wanna,
at this point,
and
Joe.
We want to see a special thanks on the CD to Bobo.
That's right.
Oh, yeah, it has to be.
So the Stress Factory, Joe DeRosa tonight and tomorrow. Yeah, as he records a CD. It's very exciting for Joe. And then you got Patrice O'Neill at Bananas Comedy Club in Poughkeepsie tonight and tomorrow. Looking down the hall, I don't see the virus. I see Sam trying hard.
Sam is really preaching at that door. And where is the virus? The comedy sensation known as the virus.
Sam is working him hard, but it ain't
happening.
He's
trying.
All right, we'll take a break and see if Sam could talk the virus into coming in here for a quick quick thing. Get him out of retirement for five or 10 minutes.
A little bit.
All right. Oh, we don't have time to do this, do we?
I mean, if you want.
Bobo is starring in a new piece with Big A. Yeah. Suicide versus Anger Man.
Suicide.
Suicide versus Anger Man. We got the first installment here. Anger Man, played by Big A, is hurling helpless children from an orphanage window. Suicide, starring Bobo, played by Bobo, arrives to save the day.
Thank God.
Check this out as we go to break.
Coming up on the next episode of The Spectacular Suicide, the notorious villain Anger Man is hurling helpless children from the windows of the Lil Leper's orphanage to the streets below. Who can stop this deranged, diabolical, demented mastermind?
Nobody can stop me. I'm invincible. Come here, little Timmy. Would you like see? Would you like to see where you can fly?
Come on, stupid door. I'm kicking you. Now open. Oh, wait.
Doorknob. Stop it right there, Anger Man.
Suicide.
That's right.
Stay right where you are. Don't come any closer, or I'll throw another hopeless child to the streets below.
This ends right now, Anger Man. Leave those children alone, or I'll...
Or you'll... What?
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 What? Okay, bye.
That's what I thought.
Up and away! Oh, crap, I forgot. I can't fly. Ouch,
my leg!
Us turn statement. I'm unstoppable.
Stay tuned for another episode of The Spectacular Suicide, where Police Commissioner Vic Dumb calls upon Suicide to stop another diabolical villain.
My God, we didn't go to break because fucking Patrice is losing his fucking mind. You want to explain?
But I've never seen Bobo.
Shut up, Bobo. Shut up.
I've never seen him have an emotion other than this weird fucking autism.
Yeah.
He's in tears laughing at himself.
Yeah.
Yes.
He's loving that production piece.
He had to turn his back.
Yeah.
He was
very
in
funny.
Tears.
Yeah.
He enjoyed it very much.
You like that, Bobo?
Yeah, I thought it was freaking hilarious when I was recording that. I couldn't stop laughing just recording this because I'm imagining how it's going to sound.
Oh, we're getting behind the scenes?
Yeah, this is
stuff.
I was just reading this, and I have to constantly stop myself from laughing because I'm just reading this, and I'm automatically just picturing in my head how this is all going to sound.
Who do you want to thank for that?
Well, I have to thank Derek, who probably, I'm not sure if it was Derek or whoever it was that came up with the idea.
It's Derek.
Oh, and it was Derek. I got to thank Derek for coming up with that.
Mm-hmm. Ah, look, it's like the Oscars.
Who do you want to thank? God?
I don't do that bit, right? I never understood that.
Called you a hack, you fucking prick.
I'm too much of a hack. Say they thanking God, right? How many people think that God actually watches their work?
That's what I'm saying, Bobo. Yeah. Like, that's what we call a curlinism.
It's like
sniglets.
No, who the head God's favorite team is? I noticed someone from Dallas once told me that for some reason the Cowboys stadium has like this hole in the roof because they believe that God's a Cowboys fan, so he can just watch his favorite team from up above.
But he has X-ray vision; he'd be able to see through.
Yeah, right through
roof.
That shit.
So that's bullshit.
Yeah, but the thing is, they practically assume that. And the other thing I always get annoyed with.
Why are you standing like Janis Joplin?
Not to offend Cowboy fans, but I never understood.
I think it's more Joe Cocker than
that. Let me tell you what's great too. He plows.
I always thought through. I always thought it was ridiculous to use that.
He just fucking plows.
No stopping.
I love Bobo, man.
All right, we're gonna take a break now, Bobo. You explained the piece perfectly. Suicide versus Anger Man, another installment, hopefully in a week or two. But that one's fucking great. Derek and the boys did a great job on that. All right.
We're wrapping up another week of fine radio for everybody.
Oh, absolutely.
So we got it done. Bobo will be warming up for Joe DeRosa tonight at the Stress Factory.
At least
the early show. Yeah. So that's going to be fun for everybody that checks out Joe as he records his CD down there at Vinny's Place. It's a great comedy spot there.
Yeah, it's going to be fun.
And Patrice is going to be at Bananas, duh, Poughkeepsie, tonight and tomorrow. Sam says we could get the virus in here to close up the show.
I got to see this virus.
Yeah, I want
to
see this.
I was trying to explain the virus to Patrice during the break, and I don't think I did it justice.
I have to hear this legend.
It's our morning show character. He's like the mascot of the show. He's kind of retired, though, because he broke his hand because he was so mad at the bit itself. And the whole bit was him to come in and riff a little bit and tell one punchline, one joke about current events.
Did you say he broke his hand because of the bit?
Yeah, we were all confused because it worked perfectly for our needs, but he was so upset. he walked out of the studio and punched these glass walls that are pretty fucking thick.
Jesus Christ.
Now
you can do that at work? You can punch a glass wall and not get fired?
He was so upset, so mad at himself that he couldn't come up with one funny line in 20 minutes.
Now the time is, we're running out of time.
We are running out of time.
Come on, he should have get off the pot, motherfucker.
Sam said he would come in here if we really wanted him to, and he would just heckle Bobo.
Well, get in here. I want to hear some Bobo heckles.
Yeah.
Come on. Run. We're running out of time.
And once again, Sam is at one of our offices just kind of pep-talking.
Sam's telling him he's got to...
I got a thumbs up from Troy Kwan.
Oh.
Which I'm is close to Kenny's personal producer when Kenny does stuff for the show. Sam is now... I got a thumbs up from Troy, so it looked like it was going down. Now Troy's back kind of trying to get him in the office.
Tell that friggin' moron to get in here.
Here comes he right.
Is he coming?
It's not happening.
All right. Here he comes.
Oh, God. He's got music in
there. Like this music.
Can we set up another mic real fast, or we got to work off the same one? Whatever.
I'm excited to see this. This must be awful. I watched E-Rock gladly smell Bobo's penis.
Oh, yeah.
He'd rather do that.
This has got to be... I can't wait to see what this is.
E-Rock's done a lot for our show, but...
Ladies and gentlemen, the comedy stylings. Let's bring them in. Ladies and gentlemen, let's bring them right in.
I've never seen less enthusiasm in my...
The virus, the wacky morning show funny man, we like to call him. He brings the funny.
Hi, virus.
Hi, guys.
Hey, virus.
What's going on, virus?
Not a whole lot.
It's been a while.
Bad it has.
So, have you been listening to Bobo?
Well, I don't know. Before we ask him that, Ant, don't you want just one fucking punchline from the virus?
Oh, no, virus, stay here.
Because the guys don't know what the virus is all about. We got Joe and Patrice in studio. I think just to set up this properly, we get one fucking punchline from the virus.
Yeah, let's
virus, what do you got going on today?
Not a whole fucking lot. Brought in today to talk about Bobo.
He's looking down. He's mortified. Joe, ask him for a punchline.
Can I have a punchline?
Just one punchline.
Yeah, just one
lousy punchline.
Bring the funny.
One punchline, and then we can get into the Bobo thing. Patrice, you want to hear one punchline from the virus?
I would like to hear one punchline from Bobcat Virus.
Yeah, the plane. We didn't even talk about the story. The plane that overshot the runway by 150 fucking miles.
Yeah, what do you think about that virus?
They're thinking that he might have, the pilots might have been asleep or something.
Yeah, what do you think about that?
It's the big story of the day, virus.
Yeah.
I mean, fucking Letterman and Leno and Conan, they're all going to have something on that tonight.
They'll have jokes about
They'll all have jokes. One punchline.
Jesus Christ. E-Rock, I do real comedy and bomb and I don't get this wound up.
Hey, hey, Joe. It's the virus.
Oh, sorry, the virus. It's the virus. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
Hey, virus, what about...
We'd like the listeners to use their imagination.
Hey, virus, what about Rush Limbaugh not being able to buy a football team?
All right, there's another joke.
Oh, damn.
Joke waiting to happen. Yep. One punchline from the virus. Here it comes. One punchline.
What about it?
One punchline.
Here it comes.
The fucking music is so funny.
So what do you think about that, virus?
The virus can't look anyone in the eye right now.
No.
Because there's a lot of...
How about Lorena Bobbitt back in the news? Lorena Bobbitt's back in the news, virus.
Well, how about... All right, topical stuff, though, Patrice. You got the Yankees. They're losing. Are they going to be in the World Series? The Steve Phillips affair. Plane overshoots the runway.
Healthcare. How about the black president?
Obama won the Peace Prize.
The Nobel Peace Prize.
Nobel Peace Prize.
Just run with one of those. Anyone.
Looking for one punchline from the virus.
Let her rip.
Before we go home for the weekend.
You know what? Let's give him the easy one from earlier that you were fucking with me about. Patrick Swayze is dead.
Patrick Swayze's dead. All right, here comes the virus. I see it. One punchline. He's going to go with one of these topics.
Come on, virus.
He doesn't understand how great this is. He gets so mad. One punchline. Go ahead, virus. We haven't heard from you. One punchline.
Come on, virus.
Here it comes.
Perhaps it wasn't made clear that this is not the virus's strong suit.
Well, virus.
How about New York City Cavs, virus? What's going on with them?
Yeah. What's up with that?
Just riff, off the cuff. What do you got? New York City Cavs.
You got it. Come on.
Here comes the punchline. And go. We're all waiting for the punchline.
Come on.
Osama Bin Laden, they can't find him. They can't find the guy.
That's right. They still haven't found him, have they?
They still haven't found the guy.
They still haven't
found him.
Come on, virus.
What do you got, virus?
They paid George Bush $7 million to write a book, virus.
Damn.
Can you believe it?
For a pop-up book?
There you go.
I liked it. Oh.
Thank you.
Hey, Windows 7. Windows 7 launches today, right? That's right.
Correct.
Yeah, what about the Windows 7?
Gave you a lot of topics, virus.
You got to pay for another fucking Windows?
Yeah.
They just had Vista.
It's the replacement for Vista because Vista was all fucked up.
Yeah, Vista was all fucked up.
So they rushed another one.
Why are we having a real break? Who gives a shit?
What do you think of
virus? Yeah. One punchline.
Windows Vista sucked. This girl walking by is pretty hot.
All right, maybe we're confusing them. Let's all shut up and hear the virus. The comedy stylings of the virus.
Let's all agree on one thing he's supposed to be thinking about, though.
Come on.
I say the big story with this plane going 150 miles past the airport and had to turn fucking around because
the
pilots might have been sleeping.
What do you think about that?
I'm sure the late night talk shows are going to be all over that one. Let the virus do one on that. Here we go.
Hey, did you hear about these pilots on this plane?
The goddamn plane for 150 miles past the airport.
Let's have something. Come on, they'll all have something.
We're letting him off the hook, though. We're all talking, which means he doesn't have to perform. Yeah. Virus, go ahead. We're all going to show him now.
Go. Plane, go.
Punch that.
But we're live.
I got that. Here it comes. I see it. You can see it. All right, go. There you go. Just try something.
I got nothing.
See, you appreciate this, right?
It's great.
You appreciate this. All right, go.
Bobo, do you have anything about the plane?
Oh, shit. Here we go.
Now I got a good one.
All right.
That's probably one of the same people that probably couldn't land a plane in that Top Gun video game on the NES.
Bobo showing up the virus.
Bobo.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, he's got another one.
And I got another good one about this Nobel Peace Prize. Amazing! This guy wins an award and does less stuff than Black Earl.
Oh! Holy shit! Oh. Fuck! That is some fucking stuff.
All right, back
there.
To the virus. One punchline from the virus.
Back to the virus.
See, here we go. See how easy it is? Go ahead, virus.
Virus, airplane.
Airplane, go.
One line.
One punchline. That's all we ask. Not asking for much. Just one punchline. Here it comes. Oh, we almost had it.
Oh, I thought I...
Yeah, I think he has it. Go ahead. Just go with it. What the hell?
Whatever was in your head. Whatever popped in. Two pilots, maybe sleeping on the plane. Passengers...
Come on, I got an even better one. The
pilot. All right, yeah, Bobo,
let's go. That guy probably overshot the runway because he was getting a Hummer while landing the plane. Yeah.
Oh, somebody was sucking his dick.
He's got a million of them.
Go ahead, virus.
Virus, plane.
You can't be showed up by Bobo.
Guys, airplane.
I love Daniel Curlin.
He's the best.
You get to go home if you get one punchline out.
Plane. Pilots.
Overshot the runway.
Airlines ripping everybody off.
Yeah.
Things that happen on a plane.
For the money they charge.
Stakes on a plane. Anything on a plane.
Anything.
Fucking anything.
Ducks flying in the engine. Crash the plane.
Yeah. Every new comic has plane material. Jesus, let's go. Here comes the virus. I see it. Just let him do his thing.
What about?
Here we go.
Sky Chef. Ambien.
That is with the prices they charge. Yeah, set them up.
Just
with
go.
With the prices they charge, you figure.
Yeah, just go.
Fill in the blank.
Virus, how about just a joke about something that you think is plain?
Yeah, not even that. Or about something that makes wood flat. A plane.
Bobo's
it can be any type of plane.
Yeah, Bobo's frustrated because I know he's got another one just ready to go.
You got another one, Bobo?
I think I got another one in a plane. I bet you he got too frightened by probably these kids that imitate that scene in the Beavis and Butthead movie. That scene when the guy goes, I am Gloria, I need more TV for my bunhole.
Jeez, I'm going to get at the stress factory for Bobo tonight.
Yes.
All right, virus, come on. We go home.
Canceling my show to come see Bobo.
I think I want virus on it, too.
Yeah, virus is just standing there sweating.
Yeah, during the check spot.
Virus, one line. Let's go. One lousy line.
Virus has no material on any of this.
Yeah, but you got to think on your feet.
Do you have any material on anything, virus?
No.
virus, you want to work the crowd?
Hey,
like
Bobo. I know what we need to do. Bobo, make fun of the virus for not having a punchline.
Yeah, go ahead.
Come on, what is it, virus? Are you functioning on Windows Vista?
Oh,
I got a good one about Windows Vista.
Yeah. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, we'll take it.
Looks like my uncle's going to end up having another operating system to get frustrated about. My uncle's the guy that doesn't know that you don't need to read all the legal notices when you download something. He says, I spent almost an hour and a half reading the legal notices, and I says, nobody reads the legal notices. You can just skip that part.
That's actually fucking funny.
I just went and I said, I'm great. I'll simplify it.
Are you reading the fucking legal? Stupid motherfucker.
Before you click accept, he's just like, fuck it.
I told him, great. I could simplify it for you.
Hold the fucker. Hold on, Bubba. What the fuck is virus doing?
Come on, virus. Let's go.
Come on, virus. He's tearing you an asshole.
He said virus is operating on Windows. And then moved along to that the was, fucking uncle.
That was a beautiful callback. That was beautiful, Bobo.
Virus, don't let fucking Bobo heckle you. At least fucking heckle back.
This music is unbelievably perfect.
It's great. It's fucking great.
I'm not tired of it either. I've got to fucking buy it now.
Yeah, I love it.
Let's go, Virus.
I love it.
Virus,
to you. One punchline.
Bobo drank two giant cans of Monster. Three of the Monster energy drinks? Yeah. Fuck me, man.
I got another one.
All right.
This is an illegal operation. You'll be shut down. Your computer will shut down in 5 seconds.
All right. Oh, that...
You know what I'm talking about. Those things that knock you offline.
I love
that
it.
That don't make sense.
He literally was just like, you saw this thing that happens sometimes, right?
Hey, it's better than what the virus is giving us. Come on, virus. One punch
line. You saw this thing that happens sometimes.
Come on, virus.
Virus.
One fucking punchline. It's getting late.
Anything about computers or technology?
Computers.
Anything.
The plane story. Obama, Nobel Peace Prize.
Yankees.
Fucking Philly. Baseball.
Bobo.
Comic-Con. Anything. One lousy punchline. Ooh, a light just went on in his head. Here it is.
Here it comes.
He's ready to try one. I can see it.
Bubbles disgusted with him, and I am too.
Yeah. This is not trying.
Bubbles hiking his robe up.
Oh, he's done
with
it. Bubbles done with him.
He's clenching his fist.
Bubbles, give him another fucking insult to kickstart him.
Yeah, insult the virus.
Come on, virus. What the heck are you doing? Are you doing what I just said my uncle does? I'm just going to say to you what I always say to my uncle when he thinks he has to read the legal notices. He says, Uncle Ray, I'll simplify it for you. Basically, it's saying, if you try copying this program and selling it, the FBI is going to be all over your ass.
Virus.
There it is, virus.
Virus.
Virus, the FBI is going to be all over your ass. What do you got to say about that?
I'm listening to a retard with 48 dick surgeries.
Actually, specifically a quarter retard.
Oh, Bobo! Oh, God damn!
Oh, shit.
He just ripped apart your mediocre insult with a devastatingly better insult about himself.
And he turned it on himself, too, a little bit.
So it's nothing
it
you can do.
Beautiful comeback.
It's nothing that you can do but go... There's nothing he can do but go, oh, yeah?
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Bobo literally went, I'm a quarter retarded. What?
What now, bitch?
All he left him, all he left,
now,
all he left him was, oh, I didn't know.
Jesus Christ. Oh, my God almighty.
People want to know what Virus is doing. He hasn't looked anyone in the eye the entire time. He's just staring at the ground.
My God.
What is it, Virus? Your stomach's growling?
My God.
Jesus Christ.
My God. Virus? E-Rock? Anything? You're going to let this guy fucking get the upper hand?
What the fuck is this world coming to?
Yeah.
No? All right, good. Music's back.
All right, Virus. That's your cue. That's your cue, Virus. Come on now.
All right, come on.
Oh, shit.
Leave us with one punchline.
Come on.
Virus doesn't have any punchlines.
Come on, you're Virus. You got
Maybe Virus
something.
Should go watch Police Academy 3 again to get his...
Virus had a lot of time to prepare.
Yeah, Virus.
To reestablish his character.
Police Academy 3, One Crazy Summer.
Shakes the Clown.
I got another good one.
Why don't you burn a couch?
When the sign at White Castle says open 24 hours, are they talking about the restaurant or your stomach?
Oh!
Whoa!
That's from a quarter of a retard. He's fucking flying through, man.
You're taking fat jokes from Bobo? You're insane.
Well, the intelligence part didn't get affected.
That's what he's saying. A couple of his motor skills, but not the fucking car, baby. It's run smooth down the highway, bitch.
I like Bobo. Bobo's got balls. You got balls, kid. Yeah. I like it.
Man.
I like it.
Man. See?
So.
And finally, Virus.
Here it is. We end.
We don't want this 20 minutes to be a complete waste of time. At least finish up with a punchline.
Come on, finish up. One punchline. Here we go. Here we go. Come on, time's ticking.
Hey, I just heard that John Corazon was reprimanding you for eating while driving.
Some of these I'm really laughing at. They're fucking good. They're fucking godfucking.
I was just thinking fat jokes from Bobo. Right.
Bobo's a fat joke machine. Dude.
You can't take fat jokes from Bobo.
Come on, Virus. You
come on,
come
let's go.
Come back at him.
Come on, Windows Vista. That's the best.
Windows Fat Windows Vista.
Fat Windows Vista. You fat fucking operating system.
I just found out that in the third Transformers movie, they based the character on you, Optimus Prime Rib.
Daniel Curlin is exploding on the scene, ladies and gentlemen.
Holy shit.
Remember the day when you heard Bobo?
Oh, man.
I mean, Virus is taking fat jokes from Bobo.
Virus, come on. Optimus Prime Rib.
That was beautiful.
That was funny.
That was beautiful.
You fat fucking robot.
Everyone else is doing their own Virus fat jokes. Out from Jersey. Now, the Virus is so fat he's got dollars in one pocket and yen in the other.
Now I got a better one.
Oh shit!
Actually, you know what
Jesus
they
Christ! Oh my God, that's fucking good.
If they put, I'm not sure how many people are old enough to remember this, but if they put Grimlock in Transformers 3, maybe E-Rock should do the voice of Grimlock.
Yeah! Hey, Grimlock! Hey, Grimlock and Prime Rib!
Hey. Fat dinosaur robot!
Hey!
Come on, Virus! Virus!
Optimus Prime!
Don't let us down here, Virus!
Optimus Prime Rib is brutal.
Windows Prime Rib! There you go.
That is brutal.
That's fucking great.
What do you say, Virus? Close this out with one punchline. Make fun of Bobo. I don't give a shit. Give us one.
He already did it. Bobo just turned it back on himself and just went with another joke.
Can Virus do crowd work on Bobo?
I don't know what he can do.
That's the problem.
The jerk store called and they're all out of you.
All right, Virus, here we go. Uh-huh.
This Odd Couple music is great.
This music can't get better.
Perfect fit.
Here comes the punchline.
Come on, Virus.
He's got
one fucking barb. Throw it at him.
What do you do for a living? Just say that.
Do you have any concept of time going by? Or is this like, has this been 2 seconds for you?
I'm not sure. You can imagine if he was in the hatch from season 2 of Lost, I think he'd be busy eating, that the whole hatch would explode on him.
There you go!
Another.
There you go!
He went from fat Windows to fat robot to fat Lost. Just fat jokes. Just fat jokes.
He went from computer. He went through all the entertainment shit.
Everything.
Computers, movies, television.
He's all over. It's all over the place. There's no stopping him.
Come on, Virus, one punchline.
What an arsenal he has.
And we give the plugs and get the fuck out of here, and we get to all enjoy our weekend.
Come on, it's fucking 30 seconds, and it's going to be...
It's going to be Ron and Fez time. Let's go.
Well, you got to hit him with something.
Hit him hard, right now.
So what is it? Are you eating the Oreo Kermit logo on them?
Bobo's Daniel Kirkland smashing him in his... Curling. Daniel Bobo Curling is smashing asshole virus.
I do have to admit, though, I would love that if they made Dharma food products.
Okay.
If they actually sold them at the supermarket. I want to see somewhere in the supermarket at some point a box of Dharma cornflakes.
Now, Virus, I would take what he just said and say something about it.
Yeah.
Because you know that was nonsense. He wants to see Dharma food in the supermarket. Smash him on that.
Come on, prime rib.
Every time there's awkward silence, it's right when that melody jumps to the high octave, and it's so fucking funny, dude.
Yes.
Come on, Virus. Leave us with a punchline.
Come on, Virus. Oh, my God.
It'd be a great closer.
Oh, this is so frustrating.
It's so frustrating
for
everybody.
It's so fucking frustrating.
One punchline, come on.
Me, like me Grimlock, me can't come up with any jokes.
Oh, shit.
I got no jokes.
Bobo's into character work now.
Oh, fucking Bobo is turning into fucking Richard Carlin.
He's destroyed. He's destroying Virus.
Oh. Bobo George Carlin.
Curlin. Bobo Curlin. Look at Bobo's hips are starting to hurt. He has to go. He has to sit.
Yeah.
I was trying to hold this up so I don't slip on it. So I don't trip.
All right.
That's all I was doing, holding this up so I
don't trip. All right. Don't worry.
All right. Come on. Now we're officially into Ron and Fez time. Yeah. So
I got another one. Is this why I got a... Is this why too many people have to wait too long at the voting booth?
Because of dumb prime rib over here.
Come on.
You hold us up at the voting booth.
Come on.
Just say one thing.
Just
you got something
fucking
for
thing.
Just make a retard joke.
Stupid.
He's the same. You're
this
stupid.
Crazy,
just go with that.
Just go, hey, you're stupid. You're
stupid.
I don't think he has the ability to even watch funny things. Like this is not even... The concept of funny is not even here.
No.
Right. Bobo is killing.
That's it. And we're both going to bomb tonight. We are both going to bomb tonight after this whole experience. That's it.
Not me, nigga.
The virus can't talk because his mouth is full.
Oh, he's killing
What's
us.
It full of, Bobo? What's it full of?
No, probably full of what he ate for breakfast.
Oh, he still hasn't finished chewing.
Hours later.
Prime rib. Transform.
Prime rib. Holy shit.
Anything virus?
Oh.
I just want to hear the virus voice again. We only get to hear it every 5 minutes. Go ahead, Virus.
You got this.
You got this.
This is gonna suck.
No, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Have confidence.
Confidence.
Knock him out of the park.
Hit it.
The virus only has one retard joke.
Okay.
You're looking at it.
He's got it. Here it is. One
here
punch
it comes.
On.
Here it comes.
Finally, we can go home. Start our weekends. Here comes the virus. And go.
Come on.
Come on.
Bubba's laughing at him.
I know. Come on, Virus.
Come on, you said you had one.
Let's go, just do it.
But what do you think? You're starting to act like my cousin's car after he let the car ran out of gas before he filled it.
Oh, you're a fucking... You need OnStar, nigga.
which happens a lot. But wait till the very last minute to fill his car. He'll wait till the last minute to get gas, my cousin.
Wait, we all forgot that the virus did have a punchline.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Let's go. One retard joke. Just look down at the floor and do it.
You said he only had one retard joke. Yeah. What is it?
How would you make Bobo commit suicide?
How?
How?
Put a knife in his hand and ask him who's special.
All right, listen, we're going to just go home. Joe DeRosa is going to be at the Stress Factory tonight and tomorrow recording his comedy CD. Bobo will be opening up for the early show. And Patrice has already walked out of the studio. You can see Patrice at Bananas Comedy Club in Poughkeepsie tonight and tomorrow. Have a good weekend.
Thank you. Let's